Hello, everybody, and welcome to Golden Wake. It's a point-and-click adventure set in the 1920s. Basically about a man who decides he no longer wants to live in the cold city of New York, and he wants to get involved in property speculation in Miami in the 1920s. I've not played this game before. It is a game by Grandislav Games, who produced a few games under Wadjet Eye, this being one of them, in this sort of retro style, pixely, graphical genre, I guess. It's an interesting game, from what I've seen. So we'll get on and we'll get started. We'll see how it goes. It's a work of fiction set in 1920s Miami, although it features some historical characters, locations and events should not be taken as an accurate representation of historical fact. Or something. So here we are. It's New York. It's 1921. As it says.
Well, Alfie, old boy, looks like it's another day, another
So let's
dollar.
Go with it. Let's see what it's all about. So you can left-click to interact with stuff, right-click to look at stuff. That's Lyle the newsboy. He's good for a quick chat now and then. So let's have a quick chat. Murderer uses telephone to lure victim.
Good morning, Mr. Banks.
Good morning. Are you
Aren't
cold?
You cold standing out here in this weather?
Are you freezing?
A little, but I have to work. Otherwise, I'll be cold and hungry.
That is true.
So,
what's the news?
I could tell you all of it, but then I wouldn't make any money, would I?
No, that's true.
If you want the news, buy yourself a paper. They're only a nickel.
Oh, you're you want me to buy a paper? Okay.
Ever thought about going into real estate?
No,
have
sir.
We?
Have a good day, Lyle.
You too, Mr. Banks.
He's not interested in going into real estate. So there's our inventory up there. We've got the save load settings and all the rest right here. I've turned on audio with some subtitles so that we know what's going on. And here we go. This is Morrison Banks Real Estate Sales. They're established in 1886. Co-founded by this character's dad. And we've worked with them for 10 years. Hey, how are you doing this evening? How are you getting on?
Morning, fellas. What's the good word?
Good morning, Banks.
What is the good word?
Morning, Banks.
Is there a good word?
Why is it so hot in here?
Because
it's cold outside.
Has a chill. He set the heating on as high as it goes this morning.
Did
Bugs
he?
And I had to prop the door open so we didn't sweat to death.
We must be raking in a fair amount this month if he can afford to do that.
Yeah. What if we want the heat turned down? What if it's too hot? Does anyone care?
I wish that kid outside would pipe down.
What kid?
I know what you mean, Larry. He's
what, the news guy? Access the inventory and all the rest by going to the top of the screen, as we know. Because we did it. Let's chat to this guy. Suggs.
Yeah,
not
Banks.
That Suggs, is it? Yeah, I'm okay.
How are you today, Suggs?
I can't really complain.
Busy day to day at work, so
complain.
A little tired.
Who would
but
listen?
See where we get to. What's he saying about his work?
How are your sales going this week?
We'll see how we get on.
So
what have you been up to?
I had a sweet old lady yesterday who was this close to buying an apartment for her cat.
I'm sure things will pick up.
And I'm sure you'd know.
Nice day without having to do any studies.
Now, Suggs, that's hardly fair. You know we're all equal in here.
You're right. Forget I said anything.
I'll just let you get back to it.
Thanks.
Thanks for that. Yeah, is his mustache
Suggs.
Like...
Yeah, Banks?
His I'll mustache doesn't look like it's on his face properly.
Thanks.
It's like hanging half off. Here's Murphy.
Got a minute, Murphy?
Sure, but I'm still on the clock.
Well, aren't we all? Aren't we all on the clock?
Right with you, Murphy?
Yep, everything's copacetic.
Copacetic, that's what we like to hear.
Sales going okay for you?
Could be a lot worse. Could be a lot better, too.
I imagine
so. You're going to share your good fortune with us, Banks?
What do you
mean?
What
good fortune?
You always seem to manage to get the best leads.
Excellent.
That's pretty lucky,
oh,
don't you think?
Sounds
I'm
like you're,
sure I like what you're
not so happy about that.
Not implying, just observing. Anyway, let's drop it.
I'll let you get back to work.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by the way, Banks, Morris wanted to see you. Said it was important.
Thanks for letting me know when I walked in, Suggs.
Yeah, no worries.
It's been a busy morning.
What? Thanks for letting me know. So what have we got here? We've got a couple of doors. What does that say? That's Morris's office. That's the guy that they said wants me. Is there anything else? What's this door? What's in here? doing some new sort of stuff, or were you playing with some people? Yeah, let's get some water. What is this room? An assignment board. Contains an individual set of leads for the day. Morris usually gives them out the more promising ones. Ah, I see. Fair enough. Fair enough. This is an interesting one, isn't it? I usually get the best assignments, apparently. These are still yesterday's. And we've got a poster for Paris. He hopes that he'll be able to go there one day. I suppose in the 20s it would be pretty difficult, right? Just a plain wooden chair. We use it to take breaks. Don't need to move the chair. What's in the box? I don't need a light bulb presently. Okay. But, like, light bulbs are always necessary in these games. All those little things. Took some convincing, but Morris finally conceded, allowed a pin-up to be placed on the office wall. Oh. Morris's office has a window. He looks at my desk. That's why he keeps the blind down. What? Well, I guess we're going to go and see him then.
Good morning, Evan. Suggs said you wanted to see me. Have a seat.
Mr. Morris.
This doesn't seem like a conversation.
Yeah, what kind of conversation is this?
I'm afraid it isn't.
Probably, yeah, yeah.
To beat around the bush, so here's the long and the short of it. We're not doing
what does it look
well.
Like?
Sales are minimal and the competition
oh,
is
it got the...
up all over town like a bad rash. I hate to do it, but we're going to have to let someone go.
I can see it just looks like a regular yellow kind of
emoji. What did you have in mind?
Emoji.
That's mainly why I asked to see you, Alfie. You have more contact with Suggs and Murphy, so I think this decision should be yours.
It's good though.
Well, I'm kind of on the spot here, but...
We're supposed to fire somebody? Wait, but... What? Why would I want to fire somebody? Who was complaining the most? He said everything was copacetic.
I think Murphy
don't like
should
that.
Be the one let go.
Don't
he
like
means
that.
Well, but he
we don't want it to be copacetic.
As well as he could.
Very well.
Do we? Nice.
Your judgment. Thank you for your help, Alfie. It's always appreciated.
Anything else you need?
Not at the moment. Go ahead and check the assignment board in the break room.
I think this will be a fairly laid-back sort of game, so... So what am I doing? So I spoke to him, but what does that really do for me? Oh. Where have they gone? My co-workers disappeared. I see.
And the son of a bitch says clear as day, he means well, but doesn't perform as
well
as he
could. I think they might have heard what I was saying.
I'd be performing three times as well if Golden Boy didn't take all the good leads first.
I think they overheard
I mean,
our conversation.
Just because he's Hiram's son doesn't entitle him to...
Hey, quiet. Somebody's coming.
Yeah, me.
Gentlemen.
I'm coming.
Hello, Banks. You meeting with Morris Gowell?
I well, would say so, yes.
Great not really.
Well, Murphy and I better get back...
Someone's going to get sacked. Let's have another drink of water. You gotta keep himself hydrated, right? So it's kind of... It's interesting because I've played a few games by these sort of developers that tried to do a kind of retro style sort of point and click adventure. This one, from what I understand, is about a guy who works as a real estate agent or whatever, I guess, in New York and decides to go off and start dealing with property in Miami, but all sorts of things happen. I guess we're going to get involved in all sorts of criminal activity. That one. I see. So what am I doing here anyway? Oh wait, I'll take a look at the assignments actually. Scan the sheet of leads correspondent to me. Make a mental note of the names and phone numbers and prepare for another day at work. Okay. Guess we're going to sit down at our desk then and get started on a day of work.
Time to make some magic. Operator, connect me to the Stamford...
There we go, he's straight into business.
Hello,
nice.
Is this Ms. Irene Stamford? Yes.
So what kind of stuff
Hello,
have you been playing
this
today?
Is Alfred Banks calling from Morrison Banks. I just wanted to follow
you
up on the deposit
created any new stuff?
In the apartment in Flatbush.
Any new music?
No, thank you very much, Mr. Contis. A pleasure doing
it's
business.
It's a pleasure doing business with him, he says.
Five sales in 30
Do you believe
minutes.
It? Five
I
sales.
Think that might be a new record.
Alfie, can you come here a moment?
Can I go there a moment? Why?
What is it, Evan?
I'm running late for the weekly share.
Oh, he's got a meeting.
Could you lock up my office for me?
Of course.
Here's the key.
Sure, yeah,
I'll
why
be
not?
Back shortly.
Wait. Did they sack that guy already? Or is he just gone?
What
was that?
On earth was that?
You just get, like, smacked over the head?
Sounds like Suggs is being his clumsy old self as usual.
Oh. Shall we go and find out what's going on? I don't want Morrison's office where he isn't around. Can I not lock the door? Oh, wait. Lock the door. And then go in there.
Let me know if you need any help in there.
What's going on?
Suggs, what's going on?
Yeah.
I'm trying to change a light bulb and slipped.
I almost thought those guys were gonna planning to jump me in the office.
Clean up.
Thanks, Banks. I have to get back to it now.
That was
right.
A bit odd.
What was that was a bit odd. I do not need a light bulb, but he broke one. What was he breaking the light bulb for? Was this a trick? I think this was a trick. I've got a feeling they've done something funny to me. Here we go. What's happening?
Thanks. If you don't mind, I wanted to go over this sales sheet with you.
Oh, did you? All right. What are we looking at? What's he going on with?
I'm back, Alfie. Got my key?
Yes, Evan, it's right. Odd.
They've stolen the key off me.
Anyway, here you are.
Because one of them's getting fired. So they've stolen the key.
Alfie?
Yes?
Where are tomorrow's leads?
What?
I beg your pardon?
I didn't touch them.
For tomorrow?
Is this
the
what they're doing?
That were on my desk? They're no longer on my desk. Where have they gone?
I have no idea.
I don't know.
Since this morning.
You know I trust you 100%, Alfie.
Do you?
But this
okay.
is a very serious matter.
I'm aware of it. Look, I'll get Suggs and Alfie together and we'll look for them.
Or maybe you could just look under Banks' hat, Mr. Morris.
Oh, he could look under my hat, could he? Oh, really? He could look under my hat.
There's no need to put on a charade.
Coming clean will save us all a lot of embarrassment.
Is what they're saying true, Alfie?
Not that I know of.
No, I have what? No idea what they're talking about.
Then
what's
you
going on?
Mind me looking
See, immediately it's starting with the kind of cutthroat sure. world of
See
business.
Yourself.
See for yourself. Alfie, all the papers there.
You, of all people?
They totally just set me up. Oh, there's no point.
Evan, please, you know me. Would I be capable of doing this?
Apparently so.
I honestly don't know what to think, Alfie. You have to admit, this doesn't look good.
Nice.
Well, there has to be a logical explanation, but I can tell you I...
Oops. I just clicked away. Sorry.
Alfie, look at it.
I keep clicking off.
From my perspective, the leads were in my office when I left and gone when I came back. You were the only
There's
one
a lot of
a
wide variety of emojis. I need to eventually create some of my own, I guess.
So does this mean I've been canned?
I hate to do this, Alfie. You know you're
I don't even know where to start with doing that kind of stuff.
And you've been an asset to this company. But for now, I think you should take an indefinite leave of absence.
So you mean I'm fired, then?
See how it is.
That's what you mean. There we go, his job's over.
No hard feelings.
Probably won't.
Here you go.
What?
See? They ain't even wooden.
Wow, he's giving me a small bit of money.
Taking an early lunch, Mr. Banks?
No, I...
Well...
Sure. Just taking an early
sure
lunch.
Sure we are, yeah. Taking
well,
an early lunch.
You need anything to read while you eat. I still got plenty of papers left.
Oh, good. Here you go. Have the only money I've ever...
Don't suppose the news of the day can be any worse than the morning I've had. Let me have a paper, please.
That'll be a nickel.
Thanks, Lau.
A nickel? What have we got? A murderer?
Extortion? Robbery?
I want to read it.
Part of the course in this city.
Nice. Murder deep.
What's this?
Really?
Eric making
so over the top of everything that I want to read. It's currently a very promising land boom in the Miami area, especially with regard to development known as Coral Gables. Is there? It goes on to state that the project leader one, George E. Merrick, is currently hiring a team of real estate salesmen to assist in this monumental undertaking. Is it monumental, is it?
Miami, good. I've always heard that place was nothing more than glorified swampland. But I'll be damned if I'm just going
to
roll...
Yeah, let me know if you've got any more music that you've made that might be good to listen to.
So, Mr. Merrick, let's just see what you've got to offer.
What has he got to offer? So I don't even get to read all the stories. What was that about a murderer? Is that something I need to worry about? There we go. We're in Florida, the treasure land. Apparently. There we go. What's this guy?
Hello, Miami.
He looks like one of those snake oil salesmen.
Horse feathers. This humidity is something.
Far too humid for him.
I've got my luggage claim ticket.
He looks like he's dressed right, though. You know.
Hey there. Hello.
Oh, hi. How are you?
You speaking to me, sir?
You see anybody else?
Apparently
around,
so.
Son? Come on over here and have a chat with old Doc Dammers, why don't you?
Yeah, okay. What have you got to say? I need to turn this up a little bit. Just do that a little bit. There we go.
Time is money, boy, and you're putting me in the red.
Am I? Okay, well, I'll talk to you then, I suppose.
May I help you with something?
Thought he was talking
Pardon
already.
Pardon me for saying so, my boy, but I believe I'm the one who can offer you the help.
Maybe.
I'm really not interested Depends. In buying anything, sir.
Of course you aren't. Did you think I just fell off the turnip truck? I can tell a fellow salesman
know,
a mile away.
You know?
You're here to get a piece of the action, aren't you?
Yes, I suppose I am.
You might be just here for a holiday, but he's, like, really too early for...
I didn't. It's Banks.
For visiting the theme parks.
Well then, welcome to Miami, Alfred Banks.
Welcome to Miami.
I'm guessing you come from up north.
Yes.
Is that like Will Smith's song?
Hell of a town, but you'll find we do things a bit differently down here.
Do you?
If you got any questions, feel free to ask.
Sure. Tell me about Coral Gables.
I'm interested
in this
Coral Gables development, I've heard.
Apparently.
Oh-ho, straight to the top, eh? They call it Miami's master suburb. It's
Miami's master suburb.
It's ready to start construction at any moment. Lots are going faster than a tin Lizzie downhill. If you want to get involved
start
there,
at
you're
any
going
moment.
To need to talk to the man in charge, George Merrick.
Right, George Merrick, you see.
Where can
Who's
I find
that?
George Merrick?
Whereabouts is he?
A sales office downtown, right on Flagler Street. Look for the building made of coral rock next
Whereabouts
to the stocks
is he?
And bonds
yeah, that's,
office.
That's
you can't
the
miss
right
it.
Way.
Of course, George is incredibly busy these days and doesn't talk to just anyone.
Maybe not, but he'll talk to me.
I like your spirit.
He might not. He might be like,
You'll
"Who are you?
Get
Go away!"
Thinking like that.
Get out of here, kid.
What's the current market like down here? I've heard quite a few things back in New York.
You're an amateur.
People are buying
an amateur.
Left and right. It's a great
know why
time
I said
to be
that.
In
amateur.
Real estate. Plenty of dough to be made. Every day, more and more locals and tourists come looking for their own spot of land.
I couldn't quite pronounce the word the way I want.
We're here to sell. Mark my words, Banks. We're on the verge of something great.
But how great? Is it going to be, like, the best thing ever?
How long have you been in this business?
Probably longer than you've been alive, son. Before this opportunity
right, okay.
opened up, I was
Possibly.
Selling lots on Miami Beach for Carl Fisher himself.
Who's that?
Surely you saw his billboard in Times Square.
You mean it's June in Miami?
Oh, he knows who it is.
Of
it's
course,
June in Miami.
I saw that. It's partly what inspired me to come
Even
down
Even when
here.
It's winter everywhere
Glad
else.
To hear it. That's a perfect example of good marketing and knowing your
Realized
audience.
I've gone over the top of the
Why do you think
right
I'm
in
out
there,
here
sorry.
By the train station. New arrivals are the easiest to sell to. There's a free
he's
piece
trying
of
to take advantage of
bank.
Passing trade. And why not?
I appreciate the information.
I guess that's
James.
That conversation done,
I'm
then.
I must be going.
Of course.
Because we're
going to
go and find
started,
Merrick.
I understand. And believe me, there'll be plenty to do very soon.
Well, there.
It was a pleasure to have met you. Maybe I'll see you around town.
I can more or less guarantee that, my
oh,
boy.
Oh, I see. We're definitely going to see him around town. Because there's not much of a town to see. What was Miami like in the 20s? I don't know. Was it like that? What's this? Flagler Street. I guess that's where we're going. It's a Smile Right toothpaste that I can't read. The model's vacant stare gazes down upon me and my fellow pedestrians. Not very nice. You can't see anything productive coming out of using that. Oh wait, clicking on it's using it. Okay, there's a hotel. The Hotel Belmont. Is Simon in? Plain wooden door leads into the records office. Can I go there? Who's this guy?
Hello, sir. Let me know if I can be of assistance.
Maybe you can. You know, I don't know what kind of stuff. Record shelves.
Excuse me.
What can I do for you?
Yeah, maybe I can learn some stuff about...
What sort of records do you keep in
the town, the city, should I say.
Marriage licenses, death certificates, property titles, you name it.
Albums.
How far back do they go?
Singles.
Not too far back. 30 years or so. The city wasn't officially incorporated until 1896, but I have some records going back to 1891.
Oh.
You let me know if there's anything you need to look up.
I'm going to assume probably
have
nothing at the moment.
Miami?
Nah, I moved down here from
Philly. I guess this is
going
to be useful
nice
for when
place.
We're trying to
climate,
find out about the sort of property opportunities.
Could Let's I see. Look something up?
Of course. What do you need?
On second thought, nothing right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, so right now we're not going to be able to do
Thank
anything
for
from that.
Anytime.
But obviously later on, I guess the records office will become an invaluable tool. What's that? I don't want to go to West Flagler Street, I want to go to the hotel.
Hello and welcome
Check in,
to the
right?
Hotel Belmont.
What was that on the floor?
Excuse me.
How may I help you, sir?
Excuse me?
I'd like to check in, please. My reservation was made on
I have a reservation.
One moment, please.
I'd like you to sort it out immediately.
Yes, here you are. Your room will be the second door to your right when you get to the top of the stairs. Oh, someone was here earlier from the train station to deliver your luggage.
Oh, that's
it's been
nice
placed
of them.
In your room.
Why didn't
I'll
I just carry my own luggage in?
Your
is
hands
this?
For you?
Thank you very much.
Not a problem, sir. Please, let me know if I
Some
can assist you.
Some kind of city full of lazy people making everyone
you can
else
tell
do their work for them.
About this city?
Certainly. It's been growing at an alarming rate, especially
is that all,
in the past
What's alarming about it?
There's no denying we're at the start of a land boom. I hear tell this
a land boom?
Development is going to bring in thousands
That's not why I'm here at all.
At this pace, we could be the next Manhattan by 25.
Thank you for your assistance, my good man.
Happy to help.
Boo, boo, boo. Music's good. I mean, well, I say good. It fits the game, doesn't it? It sounds like the kind of thing you'd hear in like an old snooker game or something. Or you know, like a pool kind of game. I don't even know if you can hear it. Wait. Just imagine playing a little game of snooker with that music playing in the background. This is our room. It's not much to look at, but at least it's not a mess. What's this note say? Figuring you might need a reminder, you take it with you. Wait, what? I can't look at it just yet. This is a photograph of his dad, the person who did run that company that he just got fired from. I'll take the photo. I don't know how useful that's going to be, but... Oh, is this like Resident Evil? Like we've got a ribbon there for a typewriter. You've got to have those so you can save your game. Yeah, I'll take the ribbon. And other than that, we've got shirts with the ties already attached. So you know you're going to have to take them off when you want to put the shirt on, though, right? There we go then. We've got a dresser, we've got a lamp. Plenty of light in the room, no need for the lamp because it's not nighttime. Dresser's empty. Can I, like, put stuff in it, or what? Or is that it? We've got a painting. Generic landscape featuring a mountain and river against a green sky. Where's the sky that green? Was somebody using things they shouldn't have been? Keep the curtains open. We got a hat stand. Pop your hat on there, Luke. Oh, mind you, you can't be in polite company without your hat. And it looks like we're going to have to leave anyway, so... Right, so that guy said something about an office being kind of down the street. I don't know what we're going to need a typewriter ribbon for, to be honest. Hope it's not actually for saving your game. So I assume... Well, that goes back to the map, so I assume... Even though you shouldn't do that. That we go this way. I guess. So what we got here? East Flagler Street there. Stocks and Bonds office. I remember all the hubbub about war bonds. And I'm glad it's all over. And this is a sales office. Coral Gables sales office. Established in this office. What did that say? It appears to be constructed from some kind of porous stone, one you're unfamiliar with. That's an interesting observation. Very exciting. Right, who we got to talk to? Who's this? Two men, just lounging on the little sofa there. Guess I want to speak to the secretary.
Pardon, miss. I'm terribly sorry, sir, but I'm just too busy for you right now. Perhaps you could come back another time?
Another time? I've just come all the way from New York. Surely there's something a lovely young lady like you can do to help out a man in need?
Look, Buster.
Maybe.
I've heard it all before. Like I said, I haven't got time for you at this moment.
What seems to be the trouble?
Well, not that you'd care, but I need to get these letters written.
Okay.
And seeing as
guess what she's going to say. She's going to say,
forced to do them by
my
hand.
Typewriter's not working. I need a
job.
New ribbon.
I can appreciate that.
I am, yes. Mainly because I want to keep it. Now, unless
that makes
you
some
want
sense,
to come
right?
back here and pick up a pen, I really need to get back to my work.
A tempting offer, but I'll have to decline. I'll be back later.
What's this say? She's Ms. Rogers. Oh, why is she using a... There's a typewriter. Why is she... Maybe I can... What if I just put the ribbon in it? Will that make her happy? She'd probably show it to the secretary so she doesn't think I'm planting a bomb or something. Oops. I take a crack at using the typewriter ribbon with the typewriter ribbon, but it's not possible.
Pardon me, miss. Would this typewriter ribbon
be
of any use to you?
It certainly would. Mine wore out yesterday, and I ordered a replacement.
Well, that was lucky. He packed that in his bag.
Thank you, sir.
Because he knew that somebody was going to have run out of ink.
By half, at least.
My pleasure. Happy to help.
All right, so will she talk to me now?
Pardon me, miss.
What may I do for you, sir?
Can I talk to George Merrick?
See Mr. George Merrick.
Take a number. Mr. Merrick is in very
these guys
demand.
Waiting for him as well. Can
I'm
we, like, chase them out?
Currently seeing walk-ins.
If we just, like, kick them, will they leave?
Would it be possible to make an appointment to see Mr. Merrick?
Certainly. Let me see.
When?
Our next available appointment
next year.
Next February.
What?
So I wasn't wrong. Next February.
Mr. Merrick is a very busy man.
I think you've made that quite clear.
Is it preposterous?
I helped you out with your typewriter.
All right, so suddenly he's going to be not busy because you've given her your typewriter ribbon. Oh, yeah.
One good turn usually deserves
I'm sure that's how it works.
Okay, keep your shirt on. I'll level with you. I'm not going to be able to get you an appointment.
Why?
I can tell you that Mr. Merrick keeps an eye out for fresh talent. If you can manage to do something to impress him, he may see you without an appointment.
I see.
What do we have to do to impress him?
I'm not sure.
Backflip off the top of a building into a bale of hay.
Land auction.
A land auction?
A land auction, you say?
Sounds exciting!
It's set to start this afternoon, around 2 o'clock. You'll find it at the corner of Granada Avenue and Coral Way.
Fantastic. I'll head over there right away.
Immediately. We're going to go there right now. Well, what about Coral Gables?
Have you got any...
Ask him about that first.
...information on the Coral Gables development?
None I'm allowed to divulge, sir.
I'll let you get back to your work.
Thank you, sir.
What have we got lying around? A painting of a stone archway, Alhambra entrance, which is soon to be constructed at this point in time. And then we've got two guys. I'd rather not speak to them, they're currently the competition after all. Yeah, what's that painting? A large building which appears to house shops, no plaque identifying it. Must be a proposed structure. Can I just go through the door? I can't just go barging into Mr. Merrick's office uninvited? Why the hell not? George Merrick, Director of Planning. Planning Coral Gables. Whatever that is. Right, so I guess we can go to that auction. I guess that's where we need to go. Well, that was easy to find.
Sold! You've made your husband a very happy man, miss.
Has she? Okay. Who do we have around? An indecisive man. I have no reason to speak to the indecisive man. I can't decide.
And sold. You've made a choice you won't regret, sir.
So Doc Dammers is selling the property. Have a chat with him.
Well, well. Fancy seeing you here.
Yeah.
Thanks. What brings you to my humble little land office?
I'm trying to impress someone.
I'm trying to see Mr. Merrick, but it's proving a bit more difficult than I'd anticipated.
Don't say old Doc didn't warn you, son.
Have I got to, like, get
anyway,
the indecisive guy
to
decide?
I'm a bit tied up at the moment.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Actually, there is. See those two sets of stragglers over there, separate
from
the
group
crowd?
On the left and
they're
the guy on his own.
Hair's breadth away from buying, but I just can't get them to budge. Take your pick. If you can convince either set to buy some houses, I just might put in a good word.
I guess
now
we've got a reason to talk to that guy, though, right?
The fellow by himself there seems like he won't take too much effort to convince. If you want a real challenge, you might try the crowd of five there.
Well, I've got to do something impressive, so I guess.
One more thing before you get started.
Just one more thing.
In this business, but I want
just
talk
one more
to you
thing.
About seller intuition.
In the Columbo School
from time
of
to time, you might find yourself needing to persuade someone.
Conversation.
You know as well as I do that that's all about finding a person's weakness and bending it to your whim. When you're talking to them, you can use seller intuition to your advantage. It'll
what?
Give you a
seller intuition?
And let you figure out what you should play to in order to get them to see things your way. But enough yammering from me. Go and do what you have to do.
Go and do what I have to do, right? Well, let's save our game.
Come on, folks, it's a beautiful day to buy some
before
land.
We do that. Save. Right, well, I reckon we got to try and convince this crowd of people, right? No point just convincing one guy. Seller's intuition. So I face a small crowd and prepare to deliver my best sales pitch. How are we going to do this? Well, I guess always good idea to break the ice, right?
I don't know.
Not like Arnold Schwarzenegger
and
Batman and Robin, but
indoors,
you know.
Preferably inside my own house.
They responded positively to that. I guess I should tell them who I am next. I mean, that seems like
pleasure to meet
that's the
you
kind of conversation
people.
You want
my
to have.
Bex. Alfred Bex. You can call
You're
me
not James Bond, mate. Oh, good. They're interested still. Now, what would be the next? What would be the next thing we could do? Just sheepishly back off, be like, oh no, never mind. We've introduced ourselves already, we've broken the ice. Let's tell them a story.
Let me tell you all
we've
the
done
story.
The introduction.
The time I sold a two-story house to a man who had no legs.
Not really interested in that story, mate. If you got one that doesn't suggest that you're an unscrupulous salesperson. I suppose you have to end that with a joke. Hopefully not about the guy with no legs. Was that not a joke, no? Hopefully we don't make a joke about that.
I just got in from New York, and boy,
oh, really?
I was tired.
Wow. Wow. Oh, they don't like my joke. Maybe I can sell them on something instead. We've done all that. Going
right,
for the kill.
Folks, how about we make some sales?
Now I can make my pitch. So I've got to sell each of the buyers a house. So there's some kind of house sales feature involved in this too. Clicking on each house will provide a description. Clicking on each buyer's portrait will give us a description of them and what they're looking for. I have to determine which house is the best match for each buyer. Select the plaque and place it in the space beneath the house. Right click to deselect when a plaque's selected. Right, let's have a look. Mr. Teal, he's a portly gentleman who's having a hard time dealing with the heat of the day. My wife wanted to move down here for my health, he tells me. I suppose I would do with some exercise, but the sun is brutal. Can't stay out in it too long. Some place where I can get fit indoors would be ideal, especially since I hate water. So he wants somewhere he can get fit and stay indoors. Mr. Roberts, he's from up north as well. Tell you one thing, he says, the biggest draw moving down here is finally being able to get away from the tiny apartment I had back home. You can hear the neighbours sneezing, so he wants somewhere that's not tiny. I mean, presumably most of the property is probably not tiny. After speaking to Miss Grace for 5 minutes, I'm taken aback by her generosity, despite her clearly apparent wealth. I don't care what house I end up buying, really. My main concern is being able to get involved with the community. And this development seems ready for my help. So something that involves the community, I guess, for her. Mr. Smith's a cheerful young man, but rather shabbily dressed and seems to be covered with animal hair. So many options to consider, he states. But overall, I just want to find some place that suits me and my Lucy now. Is that a person? Or is that a pet? With the animal here, I'm just thinking. Mr. Jones is very jolly and seems incredibly active. I just came from a golf tournament this morning, and in a few hours I've got a tennis lesson. There's nothing I love more than being outdoors in this fantastic weather. So is there a house that's just like a wall with a lot of outside space? Right, what have we got? 124 Madrid Street. Perfect for those seeking convenience. The house is small, a single-story home located within a very close proximity of a school, a church, and shops. As a result, it's somewhat loud. Right. If you have a bit more to spend, 707 Escobar Avenue residence is a large, spacious, single-story home in a secluded area of town. Since there aren't many other houses around, the area is not particularly well lit at night. Does that help me? The very definition of affordable quality. Small two-story house situated in a fairly busy street. Area reports little to no crime. The guy with the pet, but then again, you might not want cars driving around, vehicles driving around. 1510 Palmerito Street. If you want somewhere to stretch your legs, features a large single-family home built on a four-acre property which is ripe for additional development. It can be expanded on, or any number of large trees can be planted in the yard. What did that guy say? He didn't like the weather. The home at 872 Cordova Street is a small home made from coral rock found on the property. The quarry from which the rock was extracted was cemented and converted into a swimming pool, perfect for aspiring Weissmullers. That would be, was that Johnny Weissmuller, who was an Olympic swimmer? And I think also played Tarzan, or am I thinking of someone else? Right, so, seems active. Nothing left more than being outdoors. Swimming pool. Anyone interested in swimming? Just wants someplace that suits him and his Lucy. She wants to get involved with the community. Roberts wants somewhere fairly big. And this guy, somewhere to keep out of the sun. And he hates water, so not a swimming pool. Small single-story home. Loud area. Spacious single-story home, area not well lit, affordable quality. This place might be alright for him. Alright, place it there in the little shadowed spot. The swimming pool, I mean that has to be the active guy, right? Who was he? He was this one. Jolly and active, yeah. Probably that guy, right? So we've got three houses to work out for these three people. He wants somewhere that's not tiny. Small single-story home, probably not that then. Escobar Avenue. Secluded. Little or no crime in a busy street. I'm going to say her because I think she wants to be near the community. He'll probably want the bigger house. Yeah. So, he was the guy. Yeah. So we want him. He'll probably want to take the bigger house, which was that one. And he'll want to take the small house because he doesn't have a lot of money. And let's try it. Does it seem right? Maybe we should go back and try again. Pay close attention about sizes and all the rest of houses. What? Just want to find some place that suits me and mine, Lucy. What about if I put her there and him here? Doesn't seem right. Okay, so I don't know exactly what they're... Maybe, actually, now that I think about it, with her, she says she's not bothered about the price of the house, but involvement with the community. School, church, and shops. Yeah. Now it makes sense. It's kind of community thing, right? A bit more spend. Seven. I think that is still that guy, because he wanted somewhere fairly big. Small two-story house, busy street, so no outside space. Oh, maybe. Maybe. So now it's just a case of... Right, I still think it's probably that one. Although, a large family home. Mount loads of trees in the garden. Well, let's see. Oh, okay. I make the sales.
A pleasure doing business with you folks.
I've sold everything to all of them. Nice work. Nothing you enjoy more than a satisfied customer, and to have five at once is even better. Pardon?
Nice job over there, Banks. You got a real knack for this business.
Apparently so.
Now go get some rest, would you? You don't want to overwork.
I think doing the five people's probably better than doing like the sale for the single guy,
Mr.
right?
Mr. Dammers?
No time for beating gums now, Banks. I'm busy. You did a good job here today, son. Call it a day.
All right, maybe he'll put in a good word for me then. Soon. Hopefully he will. Back to the map. back to the street. I guess we just go back and rest in the hotel because we've done a good day's work today. And it's the only place we can go anyway, apparently. Fair enough. Anyway. Yeah, it's basically just a snooker game.
I have a message for you when you get a chance.
But with other stuff going on. Oh, you've got a message for me. I believe I have a message for you.
How may I help you, sir?
You said you had a message.
Yes, sir.
How may I help
George
you, sir?
Derek at the Coral Gables sales office.
I had a message. What? Oh, yeah.
At your earliest convenience.
You just told me
Fantastic.
About it. There we go, Luke. We already impressed him enough. Well, maybe... Here, you can't rest on the bed anyway. Or can you? No mood to sleep right now. I guess we gotta go to the guy's office then and see if he's decided to speak to me. You know? It's about the only thing we can do right now. I can't, like, move any faster to get there. One walks a bit weirdly. Right, so that was the guy's office. Yeah, double clicking doesn't do anything. I thought maybe, like some of these games, you know, you could double click and you just go straight there. Nah. No chance. Okay, am I allowed to see him now?
What may I do for you, sir?
I'm here to see Mr. Merrick.
Because
I sold five houses. Five whole houses.
Well,
hopefully the whole houses.
I'll let you get back to your work.
Thank you, sir.
Hopefully they haven't fallen into disrepair or something. So what do I do? Just go in? Okay, yeah.
Come in.
This must be Mr. Merrick.
I'm Alfred Banks. You wanted to see me?
Ah, yes, of course. Mr. Banks.
It's an interesting face.
Please come in. Make yourself at home.
Very wide jaw. Strong handshake, I'm sure.
Please, have a seat.
One of those ones where he just crushes your hand.
That's
the best place to start, right?
Finally meet you, Mr. Merrick. Like I said, my name is Alfred Banks, and...
I know who you are, Mr. Banks. I was well aware of your father's work up north. It seems apparent that you are eagerly following in his footsteps. You've gotten my attention.
Trying to.
Now let's
after getting fired unceremoniously from a job we were doing well at.
More than just talent. He needs ability and...
Just dumped out, you know.
I've got those in spades.
You're certainly confident, I'll give you that.
Because those two guys were jealous.
I have a few small setbacks which I need to deal with.
And one of them was getting fired.
Serve as an excellent proving ground for you.
Does he?
Think of it as an extended job interview.
He's very...
What do you need?
I can give you more details as you need currently.
He looks like a very sort of...
The first is a man living on a prime piece of land.
The perfect kind of description of a kind of...
The second...
Rich landowner, doesn't he?
Advertising. And
in that picture.
Is getting back...
But he just looks like a teacher, so there you go. What's the holdout
What's
all about?
What's the story with the holdout? There's a stretch of land which is of great interest to me in the area of Anastasia Avenue. Currently, the land is owned by an individual who has no interest in selling.
Does he teach a particular subject, or...?
He wants to keep it. Unfortunately, business is business, and I need that land to complete a very important project.
Also, we got to steal someone's land off them. That's nice. I'd rather not do that if I could.
What's the story with...
Okay, it's just the same thing again.
He's built himself up. Unfortunately, I need you.
Okay, well, we did that already. Publicity.
What about your need for publicity?
Any project, no matter how good it is doomed to fail if nobody knows about it. I've managed
really?
To secure some decent advertising, but
maybe,
I need something more.
Maybe they know
the
him.
The story of Coral Gables needs to make headlines. I'd like you to head over to the Miami Herald building and...
Maybe they were like, hey, this guy, I don't like him. I don't know. Is he a nice teacher? Maybe he's a nice teacher. I shouldn't say these things. And the plans.
What about your design plans?
I regret to say that a set of design plans...
The only thing is his mouth. Look, his mouth's like shifted over a wee bit. It's like over to the side slightly.
A spy sent from my competitor.
Is it just me? The left-hand side of his mouth is next to his nostril there. And the right-hand side's like there.
In town, I need you to infiltrate his company and take back the plans. I'll have my secretary set up an interview for you.
Maybe he's got a constant smirk on his face.
Take a set of dummy plans and leave it in place of the real ones so Riley doesn't get suspicious.
So basically
infiltrate
he wants me to do
company.
Criminal
that entail
things.
Exactly.
My guess is that Riley will have
fraud
stored away in his office someplace. You may need to do a bit of searching.
Unscrupulous practices.
I know it's asking for quite a bit.
I think so, sir. I'll do as much as I can within legal means.
I don't think he wants you
I'm not asking you
to do that.
Anything.
Yeah, sure you're not.
You're just taking back something that was already stolen.
Oh, that's okay
think
then.
As a repossession.
Right, I'll so he wants me to do all these things that are morally dubious.
You seem the type
and then maybe he'll work with me.
I have a feeling I can expect great things from you.
That's good. Right, so I guess that's all. Look at that, he's got a lovely patio. He's lucky to be able to have a cozy little spot to take his mind off things. I can't see anything productive coming out of using that. Can we take his hat? Alright, so I'll automatically take my hat when I leave. What are the papers then? Several brochures and pamphlets advertising real estate around the city. I'm sure they serve a motivational purpose. Maybe they're the first ones he sold or something. An English teacher, right? Well, as long as he's an alright teacher. Right, he takes his hat immediately. Because it's rude to keep your hat on indoors or something. Right then. So, where are we going? The first one he said was the holdout, right? On Anastasia Avenue. I think. So this will be the house. A door. A house, a door. Double doors of the house made of an expensive looking wood. The house is a very nice two-story affair constructed in a Mediterranean style. Which seems to be fairly consistent with Coral Gables. Right, let's go and just get cut right to the chase. Chat to the guy.
Yes? May I help you?
Yeah, I'm here to steal your house off you.
My name is Alfred Banks, and whatever it is you're selling, I'm not interested.
He's a bogus gas man.
I'm not here to sell you anything. In fact, quite the contrary.
Oh, I see. Merrick sent you, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
Look,
can't lie, right?
Back and tell him exactly
you could lie.
All the others, nothing doing. I bought this land before he got his little vision, and I intend to keep it.
Oh.
I tried appeasing him by building my house to match his.
I don't think this is
going to
be easy,
style,
is it?
But apparently, even that wasn't good enough. I did everything.
What's he wanting to build there? It's the 20s. It's not like he's going to build
a
shopping mall or something,
is
it?
I'm no longer drawing breath. Good day to you, sir.
Oh. It's very forceful. So, he says he's got everything in order. I guess we could maybe go and visit the records office and see if he does. I mean, that would be the next thing to do, right? Prove that he actually doesn't. Ron Weasley. The hair's slightly the wrong colour, but yeah, yeah. And he didn't... Does he wear glasses? Okay, well, let's find out. Who's that?
What can I do for you?
I want a record. Who's that guy on the wall, I wonder?
There's a house at 1251 Anastasia Avenue that I need some information on.
What kind of info?
Let me go have a look.
Who's that picture of? Was that guy we talked to earlier?
Yes, here we are. Belongs to one Ernest Mathers.
Ernest Mathers, that's his name.
Might I have a copy of the document?
Obviously, yeah, well.
I'm working with Mr. George Merrick.
He does resemble him a bit in the face, didn't he?
Of utmost importance to his acquisition of the land.
All right, you can take this copy.
Thank you for your help.
He's secretly hiding magic users in his house. Large list of rules and regulations on the wall in a glass frame. Begin to read them, but lose interest very quickly. Yeah, I agree. H.M. Flagler is the person in the plaque, so not the doctor guy we were talking to. Right, can I look at that record? See that it was constructed 6 months ago. According to this, he had a cursory inspection performed. Looking further, we see there were no permits pulled for any of the construction work done. He may have tried to appease Merrick, but it seems he did so very half-assed. Very half-assed. Just with one cheek sitting on there. So is that a way around something? Can we get him out of the house by threatening him over his permits? 1920s property speculation. Blackmail people to get their house off them. It's absolutely, absolute scum. Right, so let's just go straight to the door with the... What's that? Fake plans? He gave me fake plans to switch out for the real ones. Oh, that's all right. That's for that other, the other story. Managed to see how using that would be fine. Just talk to him then. Going back to Ron.
You again?
Ron's house. What do you want? Whose house? What do I want? I want to show you this.
Mr. Mathers, I've just been to the Hall of Records.
Because I don't think you're entirely above board, mate.
Yes, and?
It seems you had a property inspection done when you completed the house, but it was very
basic.
Furthermore, you didn't pull any construction permits.
I didn't need
He's in trouble.
I haven't done any exterior work.
Nevertheless, I'm afraid I'll need to perform an inspection of your home.
Wait,
as a matter of record.
I'm not an inspector.
Look, you can either let me come in
and
do a brief
I'm just here to inspect your home, you know. You'll have to let me in.
You can deal with
or punishment. I'm telling you, I have to.
Fine, come in.
What are we going to do now? Take a wee hammer out of my pocket and smash his windows and say, look, you haven't made that window properly. Oh, that counter's really nice, but look, it's got a massive hole in it. Search the room for violations at the bottom. Water damage, mold, water leaks, cracked tiles, old baseboard, loose tiles, uneven rafters. Is this turned into a hidden object game now? Right, well, those are cracked tiles.
Your floor tiles are severely cracked here. Do you regularly,
have elephants as house guests?
No. I mean, my mother-in-law hasn't
yeah,
seen the new house
that's
yet.
The trouble, right? He might
that was a joke.
Use like a, what?
I'm sure it was.
Death curse on me or something. I don't know. Is that the kind of thing they have? There's definitely mold over there.
This wall shows clear signs of water
damage. Okay, water damage, whatever.
Probably have a cracked pipe somewhere back there.
Yeah, he might zap me into next week.
I suppose that would explain it.
Yeah, maybe, but, you know, if you'd had the construction checked properly, none of these things would be a problem. That's mold.
What a nasty build-up of mold you have here.
My wife told me she'd clean it up.
She told you she'd clean up the mold. Right, okay. And you couldn't do it yourself, no? There's a leak there.
What a mess. You clearly have a problem with a
water. Or maybe he was doing the dishes and he spilled some water on the floor.
But he's yet to get back to me.
All right. The plumber isn't there. He's got all the excuses. Old baseboard, loose tile. Do we have any loose tiles? And surely the cracked tiles are loose, right? Is that loose?
These baseboards look like they were
installed
during the Roosevelt administration.
No, they're supposed to look like that.
1921.
It makes them seem classic.
Oh, it makes them seem classic that they're falling apart, does it? Hey, your house is falling apart. Oh yeah, it's just rustic charm.
Your fireplace seems
there we go. Loose
go
tiles.
Some of its tiles.
Oh, yes. I've been meaning to fix those.
He's got an illegal gazebo. What's illegal about a gazebo? Is he not allowed to have one? Or is he holding all sorts of contraband in his gazebo? Smash his window.
Nice gazebo. I hope you know you need to have a permit to have one of those.
I think we've got him, to be honest. I think we've got him to rights already.
Ignorance of rules is no excuse, Mr. Mathers.
Because, you know, so far everything's been wrong. And look at these rafters. That's definitely higher than that, so.
Uneven rafters are quite the hazard. This whole roof could come tumbling
I think someone
down.
Will be knocking the whole house down, to be honest.
You seem to have several problems
Maybe.
In this home. Are you sure you performed a thorough inspection?
Well, yes. Yeah, I'm sure I did.
I see.
I'm sorry,
and
but what I've seen
exactly.
does not suggest that.
Why it was a man. Yes, a man from the
It was
city.
A man.
And did you happen
okay.
to get this man's name?
Well, no, I
I wasn't aware of people having names.
Really
what are you talking about? You had a name?
Did you?
No, I paid someone to say they had done one on the public record. You won't tell anyone, will you?
Well, see, now he's committed a crime, so now I don't feel so bad about taking his house off him. Because this is a dangerous house. It could have collapsed on someone, mostly him, but
information on your report. This doesn't look good any way you cut it.
Please, I have money. How much to get you to look the
other
way?
Sorry, you haven't got
I'm
enough.
I'm afraid my silence can't be bought, Mr. Mathers. However,
no, I have.
You might be able to
I
get
have
yourself
ethics
out of this jam if
values.
You sell your house and land to Mr. Merrick.
So this is what it's come to.
Yeah.
I see how it is. You come in here, play in the white knight, but you're no better than
no better than
the
rest
of them.
Listen, mate. You're hardly arguing from a position of moral superiority here,
Fine.
Are you?
I'll call
you know, you
Mr.
built a house,
Merrick
no plans.
I hope you can live with yourself, you snake.
I'm sure I'll manage. Have a nice afternoon, sir.
The way I see it, I think I kind of saved his life there. House would probably collapse on his head. Right, well, let's have a look. I think we've probably done that one then. What's the next little story we can do? Miami Herald and Riley's Real Estate. Let's go there first. Oh, Riley's is the last one that he said, so...
Quite an operation they've got going on.
Yeah, four tables.
Hello, sir. Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Four whole desks. Amazing. I guess we'll speak to the person who just talked to me then.
May I have a moment?
You may.
Tell me who you are.
Banks, and I believe you have the advantage.
Marjorie Stoneman Douglas.
Pleasure. What is it you do around here, Ms. Douglas?
I write articles, conduct interviews, and investigate stories. I'm what's commonly referred to in this business as a reporter.
It's a little bit of sarcasm there.
A silly question on my part.
Well, at least you can admit
it. Just a small touch.
That puts you ahead of most.
So I want to talk to you about Coral Gables.
On George Merrick's Coral Gables project?
Don't know that I'd have to. He spent a small fortune on advertising.
Oh well.
I doubt there's a single.
But you know, maybe he just wants.
Who hasn't heard of it by
maybe
now.
He just wants the local
that
press to be supportive.
May not exactly be the case. Mr. Merrick asked me to come here and inquire about possibly like, getting someone to do a bit of publicity for him.
Ah, suddenly it all becomes clear. Let's get something straight right now. I'm not some dumb Dora at any.
Nor would I suggest you are.
If Merrick wants a reporter in his pocket, it'll have to be someone else. I'm far too busy to find myself on the leash of some land developer and his cronies.
What kind of deal are we
now,
talking about?
Let's not be so hasty. I'm sure Mr. Merrick isn't looking for a lapdog. Just someone who can provide some help.
I think we've maybe...
Maybe we can reach some sort of...
I think
of
we're maybe
agreement.
Pushing her a bit much.
Now that you mention it, maybe we can.
Oh, okay. Maybe
okay.
We can.
I'll help you out if you do me a favor.
Ah, well,
first.
Of course.
Name it.
There's a story I've been following.
It's always the
but
way.
I hit a bit of a roadblock. Are you familiar with Jeremiah Miller?
No, I'm not familiar with any of the people in this world.
County commissioner, in fact, very outspoken on the subject of prohibition. I have reason
right.
to believe, however, that he's full of hot air.
Well, you think he's you think
I've
he's
never been able to get close
slamming
to
down.
To see if my hunch is right.
So
drinks all day long.
Miller enjoys spending
he
his
wants
time
prohibition so he can have all the alcohol to himself. Is that what it is?
I figure if he's going to indulge in any illicit pastimes, that would be his ideal spot. As I am of the fairer sex and therefore not allowed inside, I need someone I can trust to get in there and see if I'm right.
And you trust me?
Not
well.
Particularly, but you're my best hope, and you need my help.
I'm the only
so
person that
you've
she
got the best chance of
can maybe get some help
out.
From.
So, if I catch Miller in the act, what then?
Bring me some
well,
sort
then
of
we
proof
can,
of his hypocrisy.
I don't know.
Be it a photograph or a signed confession. I'm not fussy.
I'll see what I can do.
So once again, we're in the realm of blackmailing people.
I do. Although, to be completely frank, it's gotten a bit tedious. Granted, what I'm doing now is much better than what I did when I started, that being the society.
She's been given a chance to
back
do something
then, things were so slow, I made
more interesting, which
stories.
Is good.
It certainly seems like there's
people
a lot
should be allowed to
these days.
I won't argue
get
with
the same opportunities,
point,
right?
But we'll see what the future brings. Maybe I'll take a crack
in the
at
20s, that's a pretty
we've managed to get the vote.
Forward thinking.
I see no reason why a woman can't make a name for herself as a freelance writer.
Also, the game wasn't made in the 20s, so...
Anything you can tell me about Miami?
When I first got here, this was no more than a glorified railroad.
It doesn't look like much more than
there
that now,
than
to be honest.
5,000 people and the streets were made of white dust. Now we've got hundreds, if not thousands, of new faces showing up every day and are constantly expanding. I bet it won't be long before some other fool tries draining the Everglades to make more room.
I'll see you around.
Count on it.
Yeah, they probably will. At some point in the future, I'm sure. Right, so she wants me to go and get dirt on Jeremiah Miller. And she said something about a men's club that she's not allowed in. Framed newspaper on the wall about the day the Great War ended. Good. I have no business with the editor-in-chief. You have no business with the editor-in-chief. Mind your own. I don't know. So the men's club. I guess that's the Miami Men's Club because it says Miami Men's Club. So let's go there. What have we got here? A leprechaun. A man in a safari outfit standing triumphantly on a dead tiger. Yeah, that's not a great picture, is it really? The man in this painting is smoking a cigar and looks particularly arrogant. Hopefully this doesn't represent the typical members of the club. I would imagine it probably does. We've got some trophies. Honouring achievements from hunting to archery and golf. No, I want to talk to the guy. Don't go straight in.
Your pardon,
oh yeah, he won't let me go in anyway.
Exactly do you think you're going?
I'm going
only
in there.
Of this club
I'm going to do like
there,
one of those
that you are.
Scenes where like a guy comes in and makes a scene in the middle of the men's club. Like peeing in the guy's soup or something, you know?
Begging your pardon, my good man.
Yes.
Maybe not. Tell us about the club.
This seems a rather exclusive establishment.
Yes, sir, it is. Did you need something in particular, or did you prefer to stand around all day discussing the obvious?
I mean, for a little while, maybe. How can I get a membership here?
Let's say, hypothetically speaking, that...
Maybe don't ask about the guy we're trying to, you know, cause problems for yet.
It's a rather simple three-step process. One, you have to be a man. I believe you've already met that requirement.
That's
an
assumption, surely. Pedigree.
We don't just allow anyone in off the street. Finally, you need to have a respected member of the community.
It's like that doctor guy. If I could get him to vouch for me, that'd work, right?
It's a simple matter of waiting to be contacted for approval.
How long do you have to wait? Half an hour? 5 minutes?
I didn't catch your name.
That's because I didn't pitch it. You can call me Morris if you need anything.
Baseball terms.
Of course, how much I'll actually be able to serve you remains to be seen.
All right, Morris. Settle down, Jeeves.
Any relation to Evan Morris from New York?
I don't think no.
What?
Well, I guess that helps my chances.
Is that a very rare name, Morris, is it? You know, any relation to this guy that lives like hundreds of miles away?
Are you familiar with a gentleman by the name of Jeremiah Miller?
I'm not at liberty to say.
What?
Come on, I know for a fact that he's a member of
You can't tell me.
Then why did you ask
him? Yeah, he's a strange guy, isn't he?
What you know about him.
As I said, I'm not at liberty to discuss members of this club with non-members.
What?
I'm sure you understand.
I'm afraid I must be gone.
I don't know why. We're invading his privacy. Alright, fine. There's probably all a bunch of guys sitting in there smoking cigars and... sitting in leather-backed chairs, I would imagine. Right, so what have I got to do? He said, be a man. Well, even he is one. I need to get someone to vouch for me, and I need to have some kind of pedigree. Oh, wait a minute. Everyone knows who his dad is, and we took a picture of his dad out of the briefcase. I wonder if that would be any use.
Take a look at this photo. Notice anything in particular?
Oh, there's a guy there.
Like you, with a mustache.
Yes!
There
is him with a mustache.
It doesn't really suit you.
That's not me.
Hiram Banks. He was one of the top real estate
moguls
in the
Northeast. Hiram Banks. What's he hiring them for?
Surely that demonstrates I have some sort of pedigree.
Ah, of course. While I have to admit I've never heard of the man, we have several members who surely have being in that field. Very good.
So, how does he know that he has any kind of pedigree? He's just like... Everyone else might know that your dad, so that's fine. That's all I need to know. I won't bother asking anyone else if that's okay. I'll just say, aye, that's fine. Carry on. So what else? Can we speak to someone like Merrick? He's a distinguished member of the community, right? I would imagine. The guy who's asked us to do this. And surely he'd vouch for me if it allows me to get him what he wants. You would think. Can I just walk in now? He's really busy. He's a really busy man. You can't get an appointment anytime. But now I can just walk in whenever I want. So why did he stop being busy? Let's go and speak to the English teacher again.
Hello, Mr. Merrick.
Thanks. A pleasure to see you. Please,
have a pop your hat on there. And sit down to talk. I'd prefer to stand. But I don't think you can. Right, there.
I was wondering if I could ask a favor of you.
What might that
you know, I'd like to be a distinguished gentleman, so...
Miami Men's Club, and I need someone to vouch for me.
A society climber on your first day in town?
It's not quite like that.
I understand. Sometimes this business makes us do things...
So that I can do the things you want me to do.
Me.
Very well. Give me one moment, and I'll have Miss Rogers type up a letter for you.
Nice. Well, that was easy. That's a little too easy, right? We probably could have... Well, I don't know where that doctor guy lives, to be fair.
She's typing it up for you right now.
Thank you, Mr. Merrick.
My pleasure.
And... Oh, wait, we can... Wait.
What about your need for publicity?
Any project, no matter how good it is doomed to fail if nobody knows about it.
So he's got lots of advertising, though, they said already.
I feel we need something more. The story of Coral Gables needs to make headlines.
Right, so
I'd like you to head... Having a journalist in...
This is basically just telling me about...
I'll just get to it, then.
The kind of things he's asked me to do. I could have just said to him, oh, I need the letter because the journalist that you want me to get to print a story about you won't do it until I...
Here you are, Mr. Banks.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ms. Rogers.
Very efficient. Very good. Right, so now we can go back there and I guess maybe the guy will allow me to join. A voucher. There's a letter vouching for me.
It's a letter from George Merrick sponsoring my entry into your club.
Merrick, eh? Well, he
very prestigious.
A very prestigious member of the community. Very good. The club will take this.
What would you call it, a voucher?
Evaluating your membership application.
Maybe that's
well,
what a
you seem to have provided sufficient
a voucher was
considered
at that point in time.
This club. Now it's just a matter
it's
of
not like £10 to buy a book or
how
something.
How long will that take?
Oh, it all depends. Likely a week or two. We'll contact you when the decision has been made.
I'm not sure I can wait that long.
In that case, there may be ways of expediting the process.
Well, like just going in and not listening to what you're saying. Well, just go in.
Begging your pardon, sir, but
okay.
Exactly
how does he think I'm
going to
expedite
going?
It? Does he want money?
Only members of this club are allowed in there, and I don't.
Does he want money?
You are one.
He wants money, right? There you go. There's a wee bribe for you, pal.
Say, friend, you've really been a great help.
Just stick that in your back pocket and don't tell anyone, all right?
For your trouble.
Just little friendly.
Why? Thank you, Mr. Banks.
A little friendly transaction between friends, yeah?
It seems the results of your evaluation are in, and you've passed with flying
colors. Have I? Wow!
Welcome to the Miami Men's Club.
It's unbelievable.
Feel free to use any of the club's amenities.
I don't understand how I got in so quick.
And of course, if there's anything I can do for you...
Certainly wasn't due to a low moral fiber.
May I take your hat, sir?
Yes, of course.
You
much
may.
Appreciated.
What's he gonna wear it? Stick it in his pocket. Your hat's flat now, sir. There
look
you go.
At this, boys. It seems we've got a new
what's wrong with that guy? They're all glancing at me and, you know, not looking at me, really. Not acknowledging me.
Come on in, my
arrogance.
Boy. There's no need to be shy.
Right, so
what's
who is that guy?
And where are you coming from?
Alfred Banks from New York. Just relocated to Miami this morning.
Let's see.
I must say, you work fast, Banks. Just arrived and already a member of one of the best.
One of the best. Are there any others?
You must really be the cat's pajamas.
Well, I...
But
yeah.
Where are my manners?
I don't know. Do you actually have any?
Miller,
oh, there he is. Commissioner. It's the guy we want.
Pleasure.
I welcome you not only
so
to the club,
we need to,
but to our fair
somehow.
City as well.
Thank you, sir.
Feel free to make yourself at home.
Get to know something useful.
If you have any questions about the city or anything else, I'll be happy to help.
Right, let's see what all the other guys are all about. He's sipping a cup of what appears to be tea, and he's reading The Mucker by Edgar Rice Burroughs.
Good book?
I'm just nodding. He's busy in his book, to be fair. They're in an involved conversation. About Sacco and Vanzetti. Fair enough, I'll leave you to it. And he's leaning against the counter, doesn't seem to move much or pay attention. He's probably asleep. That's what they do in these kinds of clubs, you know, they just have a nap. I'm taken aback by the incredibly strong scent of alcohol emanating from the man. Well, you know, he's clearly been sneaking his liquor from somewhere. Ah, so there you go. Prohibition, but this guy's just sitting there absolutely out of it. Right, that's interesting. I think we might have
Mr.
a little
what can I help you with,
direction
thanks.
To go with a conversation there. But let's try and get him on side first. If we get him to talk about himself for a while, you know, he'll be really happy.
So, you're a county commissioner.
Indeed I am.
What does that entail exactly?
He'll love to tell you all about his responsibilities and how, you know,
I'm one of several elected officials who run
how important he is.
It's not a bad jumping point if you, like me, are interested in furthering your political career. Your best bet is to find a platform and rally up supporters. After that, climbing the ladder is duck soup.
Duck soup.
So my game is real estate, not politics.
What does that mean in that
There's
context? I don't know.
We're both out to screw the next chump over.
Who said that? I didn't say that.
Brothers.
Isn't that a bit cynical, sir?
Oh, it's a necessary
more than a little,
in this business, my friend.
More than a
now,
little.
Don't dismiss my idea so easily, Banks. You've got the makings of a politician in you.
So he does.
I wouldn't be surprised to see you in office somewhere within the next few years.
Well, I don't know about that, but, you know, I'd like to just deal with what
I've
I'm doing right now, if possible.
A strong stance on the subject of prohibition.
You heard correctly, Banks.
I have a what are you going to tell me? No, oh, do you? Is that right? Don't get me wrong. What a man does, zero tolerance, he says. Business. Zero tolerance.
People going out on the town and getting smoked? It's unacceptable.
For alcoholism.
Just a minute. Are you saying you're fine with a man drinking in his own home?
Well, come now, old sport. Don't be naive.
Well, every but man surely prohibition means you're not supposed to have it at all.
For the masses, not the
right, of course. If it's yeah, you're more important than them, ours, so
that's where the problem lies.
You get to do what you want.
We have to enforce. Just look at this place. I've made sure we're as dry as a bone. Nobody is the
does he know, do you think? Do you think does he not know? Can he not smell that old guy over there? I'm hearing muttering from everyone else. Tell me about Miami.
Have you lived here long?
About 20 years, in
wow.
fact.
But,
this
so,
city has grown considerably since then.
It was like a dust bowl.
To be involved in its government.
Great.
Know anything about the other club members? They seem a bit cold.
They seem cold.
Yeah, don't let them
they're
get
just,
to you.
They're shy around new members, around I new sure members. They are. Yeah, I bet
Soon
they are.
Soon enough, they'll warm up to you and they'll be like your second friend.
I bet they are.
In any case, the bookworm over there is Carlton Meeks. From what I understand, he's
All
in
right.
the real estate game.
He's in real estate.
Two gents over there are John Norris Sr. and Jr. Not a day goes by, they aren't in here having some sort of squabble. And finally,
always
the
arguing.
Gentleman leaning on
the,
the
esteemed gentleman, the
Franklin
bloody steaming Edwards. Gentleman leaning on the counter.
I don't think I've seen his face in years. He tends to keep to himself, you see. They're not the liveliest bunch, but they'll grow on you.
They'll grow on me, will they? So tell us about your distinguished guest.
Mr. Miller, this may be none of my business, but I was just trying to talk to the fellow over there by the counter, and, well, he's got a very strong scent of alcohol on him. I felt a bit woozy just standing next to him.
Oops.
You don't say. I suppose that would explain
That would
quite
explain
a
quite a bit, would it?
This won't do. No, sir.
Oh, see, now he has to kick him out. Because if he doesn't, then his zero tolerance policy will be unbelievable.
Evans! Are you drunk? Evans, answer me.
Hang on a sec.
Good Lord, how much have you had? You're a hazard. What if I wanted to light a cigarette? You're a disgrace to the good name of this club.
I would hope that he probably wouldn't, Why? He just totally slugged him. Knocked him out cold. Like, stop telling me not to drink. Bang! And there are the dangers of... Yeah. Extreme... behavior. But look what came out of his pocket. A wee flask. What's in there? Engraved silver flask. And it's definitely alcohol. Oh, he's a liar too. So there we go. Let's take that to the paper. And presumably that's all they
Your
need.
Hat, sir. Thank
that's
you.
All she wants. All that she wants. Is that guy's hip flask? And now she'll do what we want. I couldn't really think how to progress that song from there, you know. Just didn't really work, so you're best just to step away from
Have
it for a little while.
It's Jeremiah Miller's engraved flask.
So my hunch was right after
And look what's in it.
Nice work, Banks. It's a bit of a tenuous link, but it's probably the
Half
best
the vodka in the city.
Well,
it's probably whiskey, really.
Go ahead and tell Merrick I'll write for him.
I appreciate your help, Miss Douglas.
Excellent. So there we go. That's two down, one to go. Not particularly difficult, really. So Riley's Real Estate. Apparently I've got to plant this somewhere here. Let's chat to her first.
Pardon me, miss.
What can I help you with, sir?
Well, I'm just,
You seem very...
Ask who you are.
Relaxed. Do I? Well, I'll have you know I'm anything but.
She's anything but relaxed. That's why she's...
My pedicurist. Then first relaxing. Tomorrow morning, it's off to the day spa, and then I have to go to the hair salon.
I get the point, miss.
Yeah.
I really sympathize with your plight.
Oh, well, ain't you a sweetheart?
I understand that it's setting the tone as a kind of very 20s sort of, you know, situation.
I have an interview scheduled with Mr. Riley today.
Do I?
I see. And your name is?
Alfred Banks.
Yes.
Just a minute.
Oh yeah, we'll have probably had it organized, won't we?
Were you going to let him know I'm here?
No, she's just going to finish what she's doing first.
Hey, Mr. Riley, you got someone here to see you.
Really?
I think I could have done that
Yo!
Myself.
Riley!
Go ahead and go through the door.
Get out of here, man!
Thank you.
We got this guy out here. She's very respectful of her boss, isn't she? Let's go in and talk to him then.
What can I do for you, young man?
Well, you see...
Hello, Mr. Riley.
I just want to have a little chat.
I'm here for a job interview.
Ah, yes, of course. My secretary informed me you'd be coming in. I'm afraid I'm in a bit of a hurry today, however. I have a very important appointment I must depart for in about 15
minutes.
Right,
okay.
Then I suppose we should get this over with as soon as possible.
Absolutely.
Yes, of course. Well, let's begin. Why don't we start off by you telling me a bit about yourself?
Sure. What will we be? We'll be truthful.
Well, you already know my name. I used to work at Morrison Banks up in New York, but recently moved here because of
just
the land.
Be honest,
I've
right?
got plenty of experience from working at my
could be boastful,
company.
But I just you think that's kind of worthless.
What made you get into real estate?
I wanted to follow in the footsteps of my father.
Ah, there we go.
Honoring the family business. I greatly respect.
See, he's got respect for that. That's what we want.
I don't have any sons, so my business will eventually go to someone else.
Oh, that's a shame.
But I still value family. It's really the most important
I'm really,
part of my life.
Really bothered by that.
Listen to me babbling. Let's get back to the interview. Now, what do you think you can bring to this company?
A modern viewpoint. The sales record's
I've
good,
got a
let's be fair.
Great sales record. At my old job, I was pulling in an average of 27 sales.
Yeah, he was.
Well, Banks, I must say, you seem to be a very promising...
How many did he say done in half an hour? Got to start? Five?
Now, if you'll excuse me, I must run. I have to meet,
he has to meet his daughter.
And I don't want to be late. A word of advice, Banks. As great as this business will make you feel, you are nobody if you haven't got someone.
You're nobody until somebody loves you. Is that not a song?
The world to me. I always want her to be around, which is why I've got these paintings of her in my office. But I digress. Let me show you back out.
Okay. So we gotta leave, but I need back in there. So that I can plant this.
Caroline, hold my calls.
He says he's got a meeting. Is he going to play golf by any chance?
Pardon me, miss.
Hmm? What can I help you with, sir?
Yeah, I need to get back in the office. I left my hat. She's not paying attention. Just tell her you left your hat.
Why is that?
I left something behind in there during my interview.
My hat.
Oh, I see. Go ahead and get it. I never lock the door when Mr. Riley is out.
Wow.
Well, thank you.
Wow.
I appreciate the help.
Mm-hmm.
She just lets anyone just go in, even if he's not there. Thanks very much. Right, what are we going to see here? We've got some paintings. What is that? What does that say? Painting signed by A. Sokolov. What does that say? The date reads May 16th, 1913. And who is it? It's Riley's daughter in a beige dress. Trying the flapper look. So what's this? This is May 16th, 1913. 5, 16. Okay. Right. Can I get away from the painting? And what about this one? Painting of a young woman in flapper attire seems to be the same woman from the other painting. Can I look more close? Oh, hello. Hide your safe behind a painting, yeah. What's in the cabinet? I wonder that date must have. That date must have, what's that? So, well, backwards it'd be 1913. Oh, 5? What's the 16? Just trying to think. Oh, 5. Could be the year and the month. Could be 13. Start with the year. Well, it could be. Would it be year, month, day? 13. 05-16. Let's try 13-05-16. Ah. 8. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I can't do 13, what? Well, I can't go as far as that. 2, 2, 3, 4. What? Oh, I see. I've messed that up now. That isn't the answer. How do I? Oh wait, if I set it to, oh I see. What did I say? 19. No. Let's say 1, 3, 0, 5. No. What did I say the other one could have been? The trouble is knowing what date order they've kind of done this in. Let's try 13, 16, 05. Assuming I've done that, assuming I'm doing the combination the right way. 1, 3, 1, 6, 0, 5. I'm assuming. Nope. What about 1, 3, 0, 5, 16? 1, 3, 0, 5, 16. Let's try that. I mean, that's the only date in the area, so 1, 3, 0, 5, 1, 6. I hear a click. I open the safe, we replace the plans, we close the painting over, and we get the hell out of here. Nice. No one will know anything. No one was any the wiser. Now I guess we just go back and talk to Merrick again. He's this way. Go in the office. And let's chat to the man. See what he's got to say to us.
Come in.
Come in.
Hello, Mr. Merrick.
Thanks. A pleasure to see you.
I'm sure it is. I've done all the jobs you wanted me to do. Some of which were not entirely legal. Well, one of them definitely wasn't.
Here you are, Mr. Merrick. I got your design plans back from Riley.
Right, okay, wait, we need to hand those to him.
Banks. Did you get the job, too?
I'm not quite sure.
Probably not.
Well, for the time being, let's hope you didn't. I don't want Riley stealing anything else from me.
Of course he doesn't.
I'll just get to it, then.
He doesn't want it. He doesn't want a theft on his hands.
I believe that's everything taken care of, Mr. Merrick.
Yeah.
When you first walked through that door, I had a feeling there was something special about
it. You thought I was special.
I'm glad to see my assumptions were
enough to do all the stuff you would have done.
Welcome aboard the Golden Galleon, Banks. I think you're going to do wonders for us.
The Golden Galleon, sir?
What?
Yes, it's our new slogan. Dammers came up with it.
The Golden Galleon.
The Golden Galleon to Coral Gables, where your castles in Spain.
You got a golden ship there somewhere, have you?
It certainly has a
castles in Spain.
It does. Now then, there's no time to waste. I've got some big plans for the next few years, and I'm going to need all the help I can get.
Okay, Chapter 2. When the groves begin to bear. This is spring 1922. Someone stuck bubblegum all over the wall at the top.
How are those sails going, Banks?
Could they not clean it off?
Just made another 12 this hour.
I knew there was something special about you the minute you stepped off.
We're making sails. That's what matters.
Say, Doc, this new office is great and all, but aren't we a bit crowded in this room?
More than a little.
You'll get used to it, kiddo.
I think there's supposed to be flamingos on the wall, by the way.
Well, this isn't New York, as I'm sure you've noticed by now. Anyway, George wants to see you in his office ASAP.
Does he?
I see. Thanks for letting me know.
Is he going to sack? Am I going to get somebody plant something under my hat again and get fired? Oh, there
she
is.
Could I bother you a moment, Miss Rogers?
No bother, Mr. Banks. What can I do for you?
Well, tell me about...
So, how are you liking your new job?
Your new job.
It's wonderful. I finally feel useful.
She's doing something
around.
More interesting.
To be fair, being Merrick's secretary wasn't exactly a useless position.
No, it wasn't.
True, but I think I can bring a lot more to this company.
Oh, she's doing promotional art on a typewriter. Wow. How's she doing promotional art on a typewriter?
The Coral Gables project seems to be going pretty well.
She did like little ASCII art type things.
If this office
is
any indication, we'll be doing extremely well in the next few years.
Have you happened to hear anything about what's next?
I think Mr. Merrick is still concentrating on getting Lot sold.
What's next?
After that, who knows? Although I did overhear someone saying something about a pool. No
idea
what they meant by it, though.
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you.
Sure. Who else have we got? Co-workers. Don't want to bother them, they're busy. Is there anyone else around? Can I go anywhere? Papers. Don't see anything productive about taking the papers. Painting of a landmass in development. Same again. More landmasses in development. Abstract art was never really my thing. I even wanted to take this painting down for ages, but Miss Rogers would have a conniption if he did. Can't go that way. Guess we have to go through this door then. Because there's nothing else going on here, is there? Okay, so we've got two guys sitting in a massive empty room.
Got a moment, Wilson?
A lot of wasted space in that building, isn't there? Tell me something about yourself.
Oh, I'm just getting a few reports transcribed for Mr. Merrick.
Reports?
Yeah,
so,
you know, the reports
yeah,
you all
some
have
random office. Why don't they have, like, separate offices? They're not
the
allowed.
Ones you're required to do?
Oh,
at least they're maintaining
sure,
their distance.
Those, of course.
What can you tell me about Coral Gables?
Shaping up pretty nicely, wouldn't you say?
What's he going to tell us? Nothing we don't already know.
See you around.
Well, that was an exciting conversation, wasn't it?
Hey, Doc.
Howdy, Banks.
Tell us about Coral Gables.
Well, the development?
Not well, no. Things
not
are
well.
Going
oh, wow, they're going great.
We're expanding every day and getting ever closer to the big project.
Do you like that? I don't like
big
it.
Project?
I love it.
Oh, don't you worry. That will be revealed.
That's
very
the kind
soon.
Of thing they're going on about, right?
How are things going for you?
Not bad, not bad. Although, being
not bad.
In his office is starting to get
doesn't
to
always suggest good.
To get back out into the field again. Oh, which
well, why don't you?
Are you doing anything later today? I could use your help with something.
That depends what it is. What do you need me to help you with?
I should have a little time available. What sort of help did
this
you
is going to be another thing where it tells
I'm
me to sell houses.
A demonstration for some prospective buyers, and I need a
volunteer. Ah, no, he is like a snake oil salesman.
I can't just pick any old
I just need that guy who,
so you want
he'll
me
do
to
everything I want you to,
them
to
if
do.
If you'd be so kind. I'll have my cart set up in a field near the corner of Granada
it's
and Bird.
Drop property development. It's snake oil
bricks.
Sales.
Better hit the bricks.
Who knew?
Righto.
Who knew? Right. That's this door. Oh, here's
Alfie,
the boss.
Good to see you. Please come in.
The English teacher. It's your English
you
teacher
like
again.
Office?
See
it's
that?
It's a bit crowded, but much nicer looking than the one downtown.
The success of Coral Gables isn't going to be about money or sales. It's about aesthetics.
Well, you've certainly gone above
yeah,
and beyond
I mean,
in that department, sir.
There's no need to be so formal. We're all a big family here. Please call me George.
Oh, why, we're on first name terms now.
What is it you wanted to see me about, George?
Because we broke the law for him a couple
of
times.
Assignment. We've been doing fantastic with sales thus far, but I've decided to
new
try
approach.
A new approach. I'm calling the project State Days. Each week, we'll bring down a group
wait, what?
Of people by bus from a different state.
Is this going to be like voluntary, or are you just going to grab them off the
more.
Street?
Spectacle.
What kind of spectacle?
Just like hop off a bus. You'll do.
This is where you come in. I want you to ask around, see if you can find some sort of performer or show that will impress the crowd.
Performer show that will impress
I
the
really
crowds. Magician.
You.
No.
You're a resourceful young fellow. I'm sure you'll find something. Which reminds me.
Yeah. About what? What's this thing here?
Here you are.
It's some sort of stolen artifact.
Car. It should make getting around town much easier.
No fooling. My own car?
Wow.
It's cheaper for us to have you drive yourself around rather than pay for
does he know how to drive a car?
You can drive, can't you?
Well, I admit it's been a while.
Just take care
it's been a while since he did his test in the 20s.
Oh, and also, this telegram arrived for you this morning.
Was it like a Model T?
I was going to send it along with my secretary, but you got here
20s.
First.
20s, well.
Now get to it. I've got a group from New York coming in 2 days, and I want some entertainment for them.
Also, entertainment for people from New York. I don't know what would be good for them. How do I get out of here? I go out the window? What's the... Oh, probably out that door that we came in, I guess. I guess. Well, we actually... I want to just make sure that I've gone No, go back in. I forgot I'm the one in the white suit. I just want to see if there's anything else that you'll talk to me about.
George?
Yes, Alfie?
Yeah, tell me a bit more about how things are going.
Clearly, you can see progress by way of the new office, but we're also expanding to larger projects.
Are you? Just keep, he's keeping everything.
Designing a luxury pool, and our largest project is in the initial.
He's keeping everything very close to his chest.
What is this mysterious project I keep hearing about?
It'll be announced.
It's a massive underground military base.
But it will be worth the wait, I can assure you.
I don't know what it is. Walt Disney's been in touch with them.
I'm thinking of a suitable spectacle for you.
Put yourself in the shoes of the tourists.
What if they don't fit?
Remember that what we're selling here is not land. It isn't just a piece of ground on which to put a house. What we are
It's a dream.
Is romance. The stars and the moon.
Or a nightmare.
The tropics. The wind off the blue waters and the perfume of flowers that never grew in northern climes. You need to find something that will excite them even more than that.
No, not buying that, to be honest. Not buying that. Okay, so we have to work out how to do a spectacle. What is this telegram as well? Sent from my brother Beauregard. Mother informed me of your success in Florida. I've come to Miami to visit you because I could do some of that success rubbing off on me. Had no personal contact details, so sent a message to your office. Meet me for lunch at Gable's Diner on Aragon Avenue. Looking forward to seeing you. Bo. You hold up the telegram and toss it away with mild annoyance. How like Bo to just show up when things are going well. Still, as he's my brother, I'll make a note to meet him for lunch. I mean, you shouldn't feel like you have to do things you don't want to. Yeah, I'll just replace that safe. Right, so how do I get out of here? Is that the way out? Is that the exit for the police? I'm assuming. Looks like it. Okay. Sorry, I just need to fix something. There we go. What are we doing now? Well, that is a pretty big office. So what do I do here? Can I jump in the car to get where I'm going, or... What should we do? Should he go and see his brother just to get that out of the way? Wow. Started first time. Amazing. So, where did the guy said he was going to meet me in the diner? I think.
There he is.
It's Beauregard.
Beauregard, how nice to see you.
Oh, why so formal?
What does he
Alfred?
Want?
Aren't you glad to see your brother?
Of course.
Not entirely, no.
Wish I'd had a bit more of a
Not
warning.
Not entirely.
Oh, come on. Who needs warnings with family?
Me.
Anyway, let's have a seat. I was about to chew my own arm off waiting for you.
All right, because you can't afford to buy yourself a meal, I guess.
So, tell me what you've been up to.
I've been doing fairly well, to
be honest.
I'm not
going to tell him much.
I managed to get hired by George Merrick my first day down here.
Well, by doing some morally ambiguous tasks.
That your heap out there?
Yes, I was given a company car.
A company car.
To imagine what company it's been keeping.
What's that supposed to mean?
I just figured a high-profile guy like Merrick could afford something nicer.
He's not going to give out like really expensive cars to all the staff, is he?
I'm working on an assignment at the moment.
Don't tell him.
I've been in charge of finding a spectacle to sell lots to people coming in from out of town.
No kidding. Sounds like fun.
It's not fun. It's work.
Oh, yeah, but it needs to be fun.
Who's to say work can't be fun?
If this is a guy that doesn't understand fun,
are you going to start with that baloney again?
It might be a problem.
Anyhow, I have yet to find anything suitable.
Well, if it helps, I overheard that guy over there talking about how his wife was a wing walker.
A wing walker?
Might be something worth looking into.
You know, it just might. Thank you, Bo.
Right, I want to... Oh, okay.
Why don't you tell me what you've been up to?
Not too much, really. I've kind of...
He's not
been
doing anything. He's just come here to see if he can possibly...
I feel like I could use a change.
Why don't you go to work
for
the company?
Take...
Morris is still peeved at what happened with you. He hasn't been very...
I don't
receptive.
Know. Take something away.
Oh.
Get some money off me, probably.
Look, about that. You don't have to explain yourself, Alfie. I know you couldn't possibly have done what he says you did.
That's
Whatever
the stuff he's
really
involved
happened,
in.
You're better off having left that place.
Thank you, Bo. I appreciate your support.
Well, you got sacked, but yeah.
It's been great catching up with you, Bo, but I really should get going. How long are you planning on being in town for?
Well,
not long.
Actually, I was considering moving down here, too.
Really?
How about just don't?
Mother alone?
She'll be fine.
Just
She's
don't.
She's got plenty of friends in the neighborhood. Besides, it's gotten to the point where I'm feeling like more of a burden than a help.
And she's actually letting little baby Bo come down here on his own?
Knock it off, will ya? She doesn't mind it so much knowing you're here. Anyway, I'll be here if you get any more time off today.
Okay, I'll keep that in mind.
Let's have a think here. So, let's chat to this guy that he said his wife's a wing walker.
Huh? Oh, what can I do for you?
Pleasure to meet you, sir. And madam, my name is Alfred Banks, but please call me Alfie.
Please call me Alfie.
How do you do, Alfie? The name's Richard
Burns. It's all about Alfie.
Everyone calls me Curly. Over there's my wife, Mabel Cody.
Pleasure's all mine, Mr. Banks.
How are you?
Are you folks from down here originally?
Nah, we're just traveling around with our act.
See, they have. They've got
Your
an act.
Sure, ain't you heard of Mabel Cody's Flying Circus?
No, sounds familiar.
I'm afraid I haven't. Please,
The Flying Circus?
Why, it's the most exciting and daring show you'll see all year.
Sounds exciting.
We got a biplane, which flies unbelievably low to the ground, and Mabel walks across the wings. We've been touring all across the state, impressing crowds in the hundreds.
Sounds exciting. Are you for hire?
Always. Who's interested?
Is he,
Have you ever heard
I
of
am.
George Merrick?
Probably. Oh yeah, there we go, he has.
Sure.
Well,
of course he has.
He's in need of a spectacle to entertain crowds he's planning on bringing in from out of state.
Yeah.
I think your flying circus would fit the bill perfectly.
I think it would. I think
sounds
it sounds
good.
Like a great idea.
But don't forget about our little issues.
What issues? I don't have a plane.
Of course.
Is there a problem?
A couple, actually.
Minor setbacks. Right. You know that whenever someone says they're having a minor setback.
So we haven't got anyone to fly our plane.
Well, that's not a minor setback, is it?
Which got a bit damaged.
Is that a minor setback, would you say?
And of course, the small issue of requiring payment in advance.
Right.
We could still
I mean, that's not necessarily an issue, but
just minor setbacks that can be easily resolved.
Yeah, one of them's a minor setback. The other one, well, is kind of important.
You
right?
say you haven't got a pilot?
Well, at the moment,
pretty
no.
much grounds like your I flying circus, doesn't it?
I heard there's a pretty good pilot in town, but we haven't been able to get a hold of him.
Who is he? Where is
yeah,
he?
Flynn or something like
Flynn.
That.
Flynn.
If we could get him on board, that would be just ducky.
Okay, I'll reserve judgment of what that means.
What's wrong with your plane?
I guess.
Nothing too serious.
What else can we say?
It's worked on right now. You know? The mechanic said it should be ready by next week.
So the plane's going to be ready next week.
Wants to wait that long. Where's the plane now? Maybe I can see about speeding up the process.
It's over at the airfield near
so we've got an airfield
Boulevard.
We need to go to. The
about
payment?
Your payment?
Of course, of course.
How much?
Our fee is $50 up front. That gets you a full show.
30-minute show. 30 minutes. Is he only going to do it once?
I'm afraid I haven't got that kind of money on me. I'll have to ask
I'll have to get some, yeah.
Sure, sure. Not a problem. Just let us know when you've got the dough.
So once we've got everything together, so that's the entertainment, potentially.
No sweat, pal.
And that's the entertainment, potentially. Let's go and see what this whole other thing was about this other person. Where was this guy? Dammers. Dammers is here. This was this job. Let's do this job for him that he was wanting. See what this task was.
So what's this all about?
The future, yeah. My boy,
the future.
And what will I be doing?
It's bright, apparently.
You're going to be my plant in the crowd, but there's one last thing I need before we're ready to go.
What's that?
I seem to have misplaced my model streetcar, or maybe I left it back.
You lost a model streetcar.
You go have a look while I finish setting up.
I'm on it.
So I've got to find a streetcar. Right. So now we've got to go back to the office, I guess. Yeah, get that car started up, roaring into life. Sounds like a powerful vehicle. So that would be in the office, probably. Talk about the pilot and stuff afterwards, but right now... Maybe we can... Go in and see if the guy that sits next to him all the time knows about it. That seems like the most likely option.
Got a moment, Wilson?
No.
Of course, Banks. What can I do for you?
Say,
she in the model?
Been around all morning. Did you happen to
I mean, they sit opposite each other, as I say.
Desk?
Oh,
What, did you sit on it?
Banks, you have to promise me you won't say
it. He sat on it, hasn't he? He sat on it.
What's the problem?
when Doc left earlier, I noticed the model street
car. So you played with it.
I went to get it so I could go after him and let him know he left it behind. But I accidentally knocked it on
what,
the
you
floor.
You broke what?
The little antenna.
You've broken his streetcar.
I feel terrible about it, but there's nothing I can do.
Oh,
you've
is
broken
that
his streetcar.
Don't worry about it. Let me have the model, and I'll see about fixing it. And don't worry, Doc will be
he'll be none the wiser. He says.
Thank you, Banks. I owe you one.
See you around.
Right, but how are we going to fix it? Let's have a look. It's a broken trolley. It said an antenna was... Did it? Is that what you said? Like an antenna? What, an antenna? Yeah, missing the antenna at the top. Somewhere where we could get an antenna. There a radio somewhere? Maybe. So one... Where could we go? Which options of places do we have to go to? Well, why would we go to the men's club for any of this stuff? I wonder. Alright, pal. Don't let me just going inside. Is that guy still about? No, look, he's gone. And who's this? He's very oddly dressed. He's a pilot, maybe. Well, let's deal with this situation right now. There's a radio with an antenna. Sorry guys, your radio's not going to work now. Seems to be working okay, actually, all things considered. There we go, we fixed the streetcar. I think that might be the pilot, but let's deal with Dammers right now. I think that's the pilot. Looks like he's wearing a pilot's outfit, at least, so... Right, back to Dammers. Right. Pop him his little streetcar so we can start the demonstration, whatever it is. What are we demonstrating?
There you go, Doc. One model streetcar ready to roll.
We're demonstrating that he's
thanks,
got
Alfie.
Model
sometimes
car.
I think I'd forget my own
oh, it looks like it's like a street.
On. Now come back in about a half an hour and join
half an hour.
When
right,
I ask
okay.
For a volunteer, you get up here before any of the others get a chance. Then just follow my lead and
okay.
We'll knock everyone's socks off.
Sounds easy enough. See you in a bit.
Right, well, let's pop forward in time then and see what's going on. I don't think we're going to be on for much longer with this, so... Let's see.
And in order to show off the
right,
amazing future of Coral Gables, I'll need a volunteer from the crowd. Who would like to assist me?
I'll give you a hand.
I'll do it.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Fantastic.
The
now,
first person.
Man,
does, do people not realize this? You know, oh, this guy's
I
just come out. He's gonna do it.
Today.
Like, oh, plant.
It's Alfie Banks, sir.
Well,
you better to have like two
like
people planted, and one of them goes,
a
oh, maybe not.
Think twice about moving into a luxury area like Coral
sure,
Gables.
I probably wouldn't. You're
and
probably right.
Me, if you think it's something now, just wait until you see what the future holds.
Right.
Come closer and let everyone in the crowd get a look.
Let everyone look by.
Now,
excuse
then,
me.
If you'd be so
we're standing close to the thing.
This alligator clip and attach it to the positive terminal on that battery
right.
There.
There we go.
Now just wait one
positive
second while
terminal.
I get the model.
Alfie.
And here we go. Gentlemen,
yeah.
Behold the future of Coral Gables.
What is it?
The streetcar.
The electricity. Oh wait, no.
What the?
Gee, what?
Doc,
hope we haven't just killed
right?
Him, have we?
Well, that certainly went over the
ruined his, ruined his demonstration, hasn't he?
See yourselves out.
Because now he's just told everyone that he knows
I
who he is. Not that.
Seems the antenna.
Not
the
that demo would have been much use.
Charged up poles
you know, I mean, he's blown himself up.
It's but
not,
why would it do that?
Probably because some joker swapped the plastic antenna for this metal one with a wire.
Oh, I thought the model was battery-powered.
No, it's a wind-up. The battery was just to impress the crowd. But it hardly matters.
Oops, we put the wrong antenna on it.
Exactly what I did.
We put a metal one in that.
But you did
almost
you
electrocuted
could.
Him.
You can go ahead and get
oops.
Back to what you were doing before.
You're
oops.
Welcome.
Didn't mean it. I'm welcome. Oh, he's welcome. Who's welcome? I don't understand. Right, so we've done all that. We've spoken to... I'm trying to think, what else did we need to do? We spoke to that guy, so we need to find the pilot. Let's go back. I'm trying to think. Let's have a quick chat with Bo again and just see what's... what the situation is there. Learn a bit more about what he's been up to at the diner. Still there, still sitting down, having nothing to eat.
Hey,
surely that if you're
Alfie,
the
what's going on?
Owner of this restaurant, you'd be like, can you get out? Because you're scaring away the real customers.
This is a quaint little place. I've never been here myself.
Quaint little place is, for that, Reed.
It kind of reminds me of the one back home we
This is a horrible little place. What
I
are we doing
it,
in
sure.
here?
But all these diners tend to look the same after a while.
There's something about this one.
Maybe not. Maybe I'm just being
how
cynical.
To describe it, but it feels special somehow.
Why don't you get
special?
A job here?
I just might, actually.
Good idea.
Really? I was just pulling your leg.
Yeah, I think he's wanting to stay in town because...
Want to work?
You're making lots of money. He can borrow it from you.
To be perfectly frank, yes. What's made you change your mind?
Leaving the city, coming down here. I guess it's just
made
me
realize
I need to be independent.
That's a good idea. You know, it's always something worth doing.
How's mother doing?
She's okay. Coping. Like I said, she's got friends who keep her company.
It's been nearly 10 years since Father died. She needs to move on.
Tell me
10 years.
I don't know. In a way, I think my moving down here will do her some good. She'll realize she has a life to live on her own. I certainly
sure
hope
she
so.
Does. Sure she does. I don't know. It seems like he's not that interested in this whole family situation, doesn't he? Seems like he's just like, oh, I suppose I better make small talk, you know.
Has New York
changed?
Nothing
else to talk about.
You've been gone less than 4 months.
I'm guessing it stopped snowing. You know?
You'd be surprised, Bo. Although, to tell the truth, I get the feeling this city will be almost unrecognizable in a few years.
If we're talking about the 20s, you know, I mean, most cities would probably be unrecognizable.
Philosophical like that, Alfie.
Philosophical. Do you need a ride in the car anywhere?
Would you like to go for a drive?
Really? Where to?
No, you could come to my office.
Come with me to the sales office? You can see where I work.
If it's all the same, I'd rather not.
Not interested in
I'll
that.
Probably just get in the way.
What about the gentleman's club? It's not a gentleman's
really
club, sorry.
To listen to a bunch
it's
of
not a gentleman's club.
Stories.
That's,
maybe we
that's
could
something
go someplace else.
Else.
On second thought, I'm too busy to go on a ride.
Or
right
maybe
now.
We just haven't been there that night yet.
Okay, let me know if you change your mind.
What, he went, hey, do you want me to give you a ride somewhere? And then he went, actually, no, you know what? I don't want to give you a ride anywhere, actually. I was just being nice. Sorry. I was just being nice. Right, so where did we see the pilot? We saw him at that men's club, standing there. All right, pal. Where's the guy gone that got punched out? That's got to be the pilot.
Begging your pardon.
Yeah, he's in his dressing gown.
I feel this may be a
is this a silly question?
Pardon,
probably.
Are you a pilot?
Guilty as charged. Zachariah Flynn's the name, but everybody in the know calls me Flyboy.
They call him Flyboy, why?
Sure, anyone
well,
with
can
half
fly.
Brains heard of my heroic deeds during the war.
His heroic deeds? What did you do?
I suppose my brain must not be intact, because I've never heard of you.
Well then, allow me.
My brain's not intact, I've never heard
during
of you.
During my first campaign, I was in a total of 52 dogfights, and I won every single one.
Whoever... Someone drew these characters, they're not very good at drawing mouths.
Of valor.
Look at his mouth.
Then I started my second campaign in 1915.
What's that all about? He loves talking about himself. 20
so
minutes
that's
later.
Basically a summary of my accomplishments.
Is it? Alright. Did you shoot down
yes.
a lot of planes then?
Fascinating.
Oh yeah, I was totally listening. So anyway, I'd like
I
to hire
have
you.
A business proposal for you.
Oh yeah?
I'm in need of a pilot for an air show that's being put
on. Is he going to want to do it?
Would you be interested?
That all depends. What's it pay?
That's a detail we can negotiate
money.
Later on.
And what exactly happens?
Sandwiches. We'll give you some
show.
Sandwiches.
You fly the plane.
Think you'd want Jinky do it for sandwiches.
Does wing walking and other stunts.
Mabel Cody, eh?
Yes, of Mabel Cody's Flying Circus. They've been touring all over Florida.
Sounds interesting, but I have one last
question.
Why on earth would a pilot of my skill and fame want to work for some podunk air show?
That's not very nice.
Because it's being
there we go. We got him.
George
I think we might
Merrick
get him hooked.
And his Coral Gables project.
We might have him hooked.
Surely you've heard of that.
Of
a
course,
big fish on the hook.
Rock in this town without seeing ads for it. He seems to be getting lots of people interested.
He is. Just think of what all those people will say when they
see
you.
Yeah, they'll
on the
be
show.
They'll be really impressed.
Okay, I'll be your pilot, but on one condition.
What condition? What's the condition?
What's your condition?
I want to be the star.
What is his condition? Well,
show.
He seems to be standing up
posters,
right now,
right?
So I'm hoping he's okay.
I would assume so. Yes.
Right.
Sorry.
I want them to make
I'm sorry
him
about
out
that. That was terrible.
I see.
It was terrible.
Any other requirements?
Well, now that you mention it, I think the name should have a real ring to it, written so it rolls off the tongue.
Right, like
also,
what?
Also, I think the colors should really pop.
Also, this, like and then that, and well with each maybe other, this too, and how about
and
that?
Finally, I think we should and concentrate finally. On quantity. I want so many of these posters around they cover
what?
Entire walls.
I'll see what I can do.
Don't do anything like this nonsense for this guy. What the hell?
Are you a new member here? I've never seen you around.
Are you a new I've never
no,
seen you around. He's
I've
only
just
joined
been
himself.
Away for a while. I don't know if you've heard, but there was this little thing called the Great War.
Sure, but that was 4 years ago.
Right.
I had other things to do before visiting this fair city again. When you get to be as famous as me, there's a lot of demand.
Oh, he's famous. Well, all around the world? Wait a minute. Why does it still say that then?
What's your condition?
I want to be the star.
Star attraction. Posters.
Right. I want them to make me out.
He's the star.
I see. Any other requirements?
Well, I think the name should
have
a
ring to it.
I think the
colors should pop.
I think we should
concentrate on
quantity.
I'll see what I can do.
Lots of posters.
I'll see you later.
Seems like that's it.
Take care, Mac.
Okay. Seems like that's all we had to do there. Seems like that's all we had to do. So what else do we really need to do after that? We need to somehow... Well, we need to deal with the poster designs, don't we? That means going to speak to Miss Rogers. And then maybe she'll help us. So she's through here. So she's gonna go... So she designs the posters and stuff for us on a typewriter. Amazing.
No bother,
magic
Mr.
typewriter, apparently.
What can I do for you?
We need a poster
Rogers,
design.
I'm on a special assignment for Mr. Merrick, and I need to design a poster.
Sure. What will you be needing?
Okay. So, brief overview.
I need a few specific
designs.
Yeah,
design we need to design
elements.
It specifically.
Just tell me what you need, and I'll prepare a mock-up for you. What are you going to want to put on it for the name?
Right. Daredevil Flynn's Flying Circus of Doom. I don't think he'll want to be in a flying circus of doom, to be honest. Maybe Flyboy Flynn's Fantastic Flying Circus. What do you want? Did he say he wanted a ring to it, or he said he wanted a name with a ring to it, didn't he? Flyboy Flynn's Fantastic Flying Circus. Something that. Did he say what something to get people excited?
I think Flyboy.
Let's try that.
Fantastic flying
I can't remember.
Would be good.
That's a mouthful, but it does have a nice ring to it. So, what color scheme are you going to want?
He wanted something. That was what he said about popping. He wanted the colors to pop, didn't he? So he'll mean orange and blue would
okay.
kind of yeah.
And how big are we going to print?
That would kind of. Have a pretty big impact. And he wanted walls covered, didn't he? 8x10s, like multiple 8x10s.
Small. The size of a standard sheet of paper.
Yeah, so we can have
lots
of them. Yeah, that
right.
makes sense. Yeah, 8x10s and we can put millions of them everywhere. Like an actual circus.
There you are.
Thank you.
So now I guess we just need to get the pilot to agree. And I assume if he likes the posters, we'll be in business with our new pilot, hopefully. Get in the car and let's go. Let's go, go, go. Get in that car. Maybe. Maybe I don't know about this. What do you think of this then? Seems like an alright game, I think. Not... The difference, I think, at some point-and-click kind of games, you know, there's a bit more of a kind of strange story going on, but with this, it's fairly normal. I would say fairly normal, it's obviously set in the early 20s, but... It's almost a kind of thing you could imagine really happening. Where's that poster? Are these posters any use?
Begging your pardon? Yeah, what is it?
I've had this poster made up for the air show. What do you think?
Let me see that.
Yeah.
Nice name. I
like the name.
That. Nice colors. Exactly what
I was thinking.
Ah,
there we go.
And what's this little number on the side here?
That's how big the final print size will be.
Yeah.
Of course, that's perfect. Well, this is just the
We did it right.
People are gonna love this show.
I'm glad
to remember what he said. He said, yeah.
I can count on you as the pilot?
Sure. Just let me know where and when, and I'll be there.
Good. We've got a pilot. So now we needed to deal with his plane. Pilot situation sorted. There's an airfield we need to go to, which was there. Probably having to finish in a short time. But, let me just check something. We're okay. Okay, let's go and chat to this mechanic and see what he's all about. What are you all about, pal?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I am a robot. I talk like this. Apparently.
Curly and Mabel sent me to check up on things.
Curly and Mabel.
Beauty's up in the sky again.
Shouldn't be more than a week. I'm kind of stuck waiting.
You're trying to think
now,
of a name for people in the 20s. Curly.
What is it you're waiting on?
And
I
Mabel.
Have two parts on their way. One's a piece for the rudder, and the other's a magneto for the engine.
It doesn't sound like it's going anywhere anytime soon, then.
What about this magneto you mentioned?
The magneto for the ignition is damaged.
You get him to like lift the plane.
Replacement to come in.
Oh, not
what sort of
okay.
engine is it?
Curtiss OX5. Fairly common engine in these types of planes. Some boats.
Boats.
Too. Unreliable maybe, piece of junk, really.
Maybe we could find like a boat engine. Done.
Any idea where I'd be able to get one?
Order from the manufacturer, like I did.
Yeah, apart from that,
any place where there's lots of planes or boats would have them in.
We're in Miami, so surely there's boats, right?
I think that gives me an idea. By the way, where is the magneto usually found on the engine?
Well, right, we're not going to steal it out of a plane, out of a vehicle, are we? And what about the rudder?
The rudder again?
From a plane, probably.
See for yourself.
Or from a boat.
Looks like something took a bite out of it.
So what are you waiting on to fix it?
A new rudder top. Should be here
obviously.
In a few days.
Is there anything that might be used as a substitute?
Oh, I'm sure the pilot will love.
A wooden plank would do in a pinch, sure.
So a wooden plank.
You look awfully young to be an airplane
and
mechanic.
A
How long
bolt
have you been doing this?
Magneto, maybe.
6 months next week. But I've been working on
Six
planes
months.
Since I was a kid. My father was an airplane mechanic during the war, see? So he taught me everything he knew.
Taught him everything he knew? Okay, well,
I'll
we have to get those parts.
See ya.
Would you mind
that?
Terribly if I borrowed one of your wrenches?
Not as long as you bring it back, I don't.
Excellent. Okay, I can borrow a wrench.
I can't say I blame you for wanting to borrow it. That clunker looks like it needs to be serviced pretty soon.
Well, my car. Just leave my car alone. Just stop picking on my car. Not like this plane that can't even take off, mate. You shut up. Incidentally, I wonder why they don't have a pilot anymore. Do you think it was because he crashed? So what can we do to get something useful? Did he have anything here? His thing's made of wood and that's all destroyed. Is there anything in here that I can get? His car, what's that? Nothing productive on there. Wagon looks garish. Oh, there's a sign. Oh. A sign. We could use the sign, probably.
Would you be opposed to me taking your sign, Doc?
Take it. I'm sick of the sight of it.
He doesn't like the sign. How are you going to advertise your business if you don't have a sign? Right, okay. Well, that's a board. Maybe you can cut that board to make a rudder for the plane. Doesn't seem like it's going to be the most sensible thing to put on a plane that we're needing to fly, but, you know, we're not doing it in real life, so it's fine. Then we also need a magneto. No, not that one. Wrench, wooden shingle. Yo, can you make a rudder out of that? A rudder top,
think
sorry.
Can I make use of this piece of wood?
Now let me see. I think I can, yeah. If I shave off a bit of the side here, it'll work as a replacement for the missing chunk of
rudder. What are you going to just glue it
thanks,
on?
Mister. You really saved me some time here. Just, happy to help.
Just glue it onto the tail of the plane. That'll be alright. It'll stick for a while. as long as they don't do any high G turns. Not that they're going to in that thing, but, you know. Right. So, there is a marina. Yeah, we're not going to get a magneto from anywhere else here. We've got a microwave, no? Okay. We've got a boat, a plane, and another boat.
Welcome to the Dinner Key Marina, sir.
The Dinner Key Marina.
Be of any assistance.
Yeah, you got any dinner?
Hello there.
Fine day for it.
Hello there. Well, tell me about
Don't
yourself.
You get uncomfortable standing out in this heat wearing dark clothing?
It probably does, but...
You get used to it after a while. And besides, there's a nice sea breeze.
A sea breeze.
Keeps things cool.
I suppose there are worse places to be standing around.
Probably, but, you know. So what's happening at the marina, pal?
Marina doesn't seem to have many boats.
I don't know what's going on in this.
Hasn't been a commercial marina very long.
We've obviously got to try to steal a bit, but...
During the war. But we're steadily getting more people coming in. My guess is people will be fighting for space within the next year or so.
Will they? Cool.
That's certainly an interesting
I'm very interested
at the
in
end
that.
Of the dock there, isn't it?
Very interesting.
Yes, it's definitely something to look at. It's been docked there for quite a while now. I actually can't remember seeing who brought it in.
That was me. I need to borrow some bits from my engine, if you don't mind.
A fascinating piece of machinery.
I'll just be on my way.
Have a nice day, sir.
So, odd plane. Hydroplane. You've heard of these, but I've never actually seen one. Well, there's one there, look. Can we go to it? I don't want to fly it, but can I take bits off it? Nothing on that part of the plane I need. Oh, an engine. Mounted on top of the wings. So it's not an ordinary plane.
Hey now, don't be fooling around with that.
But it's mine, I've told you, it's my plane. I'm going to need to get somebody to... Oh, is this why we were offering him a car ride earlier? I think we'll try and get the plane sorted out. And then we'll probably finish up for tonight, I think. So, where was I going to go? Oh yeah, down to this diner. If he can get his brother to come with him, maybe he can distract the guard. Get him to...
Hey, Bo.
Hop Alfie, in the car with us.
What's going on?
Hey, I'm offering you a ride, mate.
How'd you like to go for a drive?
Really? Where to?
Marina.
How about Dinner Key Marina? You can look at the boats in the ocean.
Sounds like the...
Yes, he wants to do that, so Let's that's go. Good. Then we're just going to say to him, oh yeah, by the way, can you just distract this guard while I steal this? Don't mind me, just a little petty theft of something that'll stop their plane from working.
Bo, right. Come over here.
Yeah, I need to speak to you.
What is it?
I need you to do me a favor and chat up the security
what?
Guard.
What? Chat up the security guard?
What?
What?
Just trust me.
What?
Oh, and if he starts asking you questions about it, just make something up. I get the feeling
is he getting his
exactly
own brother to...
In the drawer.
Okay.
He just means to talk to him, really, in this the context of this. Right, so I guess we need the wrench for this engine. Surely he's going to see me go past. Well, I'm too busy chatting to this person here. I got the magneto. Now let's get the hell out of here.
Come on, Bo. Let's head back.
Yeah, it's time for us to go. That guy's the worst guard ever. The noise of that car starting up. Might be healthy for the
that
time.
That was fun. I'm glad we made it back in one piece.
So am
Thanks
I.
For the ride, Alfie.
No bother. Oh, look, are they sitting down now? Is that the people? Oh no, they're still over there. Who's this? Some random people sitting down. So... Let's give that to the guy, and he can have his wrench back as well. Or maybe I can keep it. What do you think? Just give it back to him. Give that to him. Maybe he'll automatically give the other thing back
is
to him. Who knows?
Is this the sort of magneto you need for the engine?
It sure is. How were you able to get one so quickly?
I have my ways.
Well, you really saved me some time. I'll get to work replacing this right away.
Fantastic. Here's your wrench back, by the way.
Give the wrench to, he's suspicious.
Thanks. Hey, you've really helped me out with getting this plate fixed.
No, sorry, I borrowed it for completely legitimate means. It wasn't a problem. Just don't ask too many more questions, alright? So the only thing we need to do with this is organize. The last thing we'd need to do would be to get money. What I'm gonna do, head to the sales office. And we're gonna save our game. And we're gonna finish up for the night. In just a moment. Once he decides to stop wandering around. Give us a save. Go on. Give us a save. Make sure it's saved. I think it's saved. The best way to find out actually would be to load it. Yes, right, that's fine. I don't know why I was so concerned about that, but you just never know sometimes. And anyway, that is going to be where we finish for tonight. So I hope you've enjoyed watching a game that I've forgotten the name. A Golden Wake. A Golden Wake. Thanks very much for watching. I'm glad you've joined me tonight. I hope you'll join me again. And if you haven't, I hope you'll contemplate dropping a little follow there. That'd be lovely too. But thanks very much for joining me anyway. And I'm going to be away. So I may be back tomorrow. I'm not too sure. I could do with taking a rest. But tomorrow, if we are back tomorrow, we'll be back to playing... What was the PC game we were needing to get through? I can't remember anything tonight. I don't know what's going on. There was a game we needed to continue. It's completely gone out of my head. I'll remember when I go live and I'll announce it at the time. For now. It's one of those nights, you know. For now, thank you very much, as I say. Good night.